presentation of ESPN on ABC. Sunset in central Ohio and a beautiful day as we welcome you to Saturday Night Football presented by Wells Fargo and this presentation of the Big Ten on ABC. The old horseshoe on the banks of the Olentangy, a sea of scarlet for this anticipated collision between two top five teams, number five Oklahoma and number two Ohio State. And welcome to Columbus, Chris Fowler and Kirk Herbstreit. How cool to have these two heavyweight programs colliding here, just the fourth time ever, and it's Oklahoma's first visit here in 40 years. If we get half as good a game as that 77 Classic, it'll be fun tonight.
That was one of my first memories as a college football fan. Last second field goal, some big names on the sideline and also on the field. Hopefully we get a game like that.
Woody Hayes versus Barry Switz. We'll talk more about that game coming up. Meanwhile, Oklahoma is driven by this loss at home to Ohio State last year. Biggest crowd in Norman history. The Buckeyes made some great plays, put 35 on the board at halftime, won it going away, and then sang the alma mater right in front of Oklahoma's team.
Yeah, and they're just not used to seeing that. No. Baker Mayfield came out this week and said that, you know, that image has really been around this week, and they're not going to hide from the fact that they're motivated by that. I think Oklahoma comes in because of their leader, Baker Mayfield, with a big chip on their shoulder. That's kind of his game. That's how he plays. He likes to go on the road. He likes the us against the world mentality, and he's going to show it the way he plays, the way he throws, and the way he runs. Now, big thing he's got to do, he's got to get the ball out of his hands quickly tonight. Make quick decisions and be in rhythm early with his wide receivers. This is the aspect of his game that's huge against this Ohio State defensive line. Ability to improvise and create. Keep plays alive. Something to keep in mind tonight. When he scrambles, he's looking to scramble to throw. Not necessarily scrambling to run to take off. He's looking to buy time to make a big throw. And Mark Andrews, his big tight end, is a guy he's going to be dialing up, number 81.
Mayfield 19-20 against UTEP. Did whatever they wanted. Their offensive line, they think, is one of the best in the country. We can't wait to watch the matchup against these guys. Buckeyes think they got the best D-line in the country.
Yeah, well, you talk about the game within the game. That big, experienced Oklahoma offensive line trying to take care of Baker Mayfield against Tyquan Lewis and Sam Hubbard and company. It's a very deep, very athletic, very physical front. And they feel confident in their ability to chase down, give different looks to Baker Mayfield, to try to spy him, which was successful a year ago in Norman. But make no mistake. How that offensive line takes care of him, how they do in the run game. No more Samaje Perine, no more Joe Mixon, breaking in a whole new crew in that backfield. If Oklahoma's going to come in here and win, it can't just be Baker Mayfield alone. He needs somebody to help him out running the football with that offensive line, trying to get a dent against that D-line.
And how about the coaching matchup? You got Urban Meyer, those three national titles, one of the best in the world in his profession. And Lincoln Riley for Oklahoma taking over for Bob Stoops. He turned 34 on Tuesday. First test as a head coach. Oklahoma and Ohio State coming up from Columbus.
The Nissan pregame rush with Kevin Nagandi, Mac Brown, and Booger McFarland is next after this message and a word from our ABC stations.
Of Ohio State football, the dotting of the eye by his senior sousaphone player. The honor tonight is Tim Hoag from Canton McKinley, a graduate in May. In security and intelligence with a minor in Russian. This might not be the most important thing he does in his life, but it is fulfilling a dream he's had since he was in high school. Doesn't get a lot better than Script, Ohio. Kirk will tell you the band ranks way up there, perhaps above the team many seasons.
For a lot of people. It's a big deal.
Between these two programs, they have 13 national championships, according to the major wire services. You can see the success in their respective conferences. A dozen Heisman Trophy winners between them. And they, of course, been pipelines of first-round talent to the NFL. Just 14 wins difference. Ohio State the edge all time. And what a rare treat as they complete this home-and-home series in Columbus here tonight. Oklahoma prides itself on being one of the best road teams in the country. They have not lost a game since that home defeat to Ohio State a year ago. They have the nation's longest win streak at 11. It takes a special team to deal with this environment on the road, and Baker Mayfield thinks the Sooners have that. But guys, don't lose on home turf often. Urban Meyer's had the look in his eye, but big game, hasn't he, the last 24 hours. Mayfield and the Sooner captains about to walk into this sea of noise. And the Buckeyes enter through a laser show. Seven-point underdogs feeling a little bit forgotten as the road team here. We'll see if the Sooners can translate that into a big performance. Coach is getting ready. Not another game.
He may cover the opening kickoff.
Lasers, pyrotechnics, smoke, they don't miss a trick. Things have changed since the Woody Hayes era. Imagine being a 34-year-old in just a few days and being in charge of a program with this challenge. It's going to be interesting to see Lincoln Riley, a play-calling prodigy, Kirk, as he transforms to the head man now. The Sooners and the Buckeyes. Doesn't have a great sound to it, does it? Kickoff coming up.
Nobody pray for me.
Oklahoma-Ohio State, there's a lot of history in both programs.
It's a huge matchup. Both of these teams have aspirations to play for a national title.
He's the quarterback you don't want to face.
We do what we do. Let's go.
This has been the Nissan Pregame Rush. Kickoff from Columbus is next, and now we'll look inside Nissan's Heisman House. Early September in Oklahoma visiting Ohio State. It's a treat in college football. You get the big neutral site games, Kirk. Not often do teams take on the challenge of a home and home. It's been kind of a dying tradition. We're happy that these two programs revived it.
Yeah, it's great to see these games in September. And as you said, sometimes you see a neutral site game, but it's great to see Joe Castiglione from Oklahoma, the athletic director, and Gene Smith from Ohio State come together and get this home and home set up.
Buckeyes won the toss and deferred, so Lincoln Riley's offense will get the football first as we say hello to Maria Taylor on the sidelines on this very pleasant evening. Hi, Maria.
Well, hello, Chris. And you've mentioned Baker Mayfield already and his motivation in this game, but he is taking it very personally despite passing for nearly 300 yards in last year's game. What sticks out is those two interceptions and that he feels as though he's put his team in a situation where they couldn't battle back from. He has 14 phrases up in his locker room, and one of them is be the best college football player in the nation. And I will say this D-line is looking forward to getting after him. They say he's the best competitor they've ever played against in Ohio State. Well, they want to bottle him up early, guys.
Baker, tell me nobody in the sport has more fun playing the game than him. But Kirk, besides the fact that he took that loss hard, he knows he cannot press tonight.
That's what he did a year ago. He had such hype following the 15 season, finishing up near the top of the Heisman, that I think he came into 16 against Houston and especially Ohio State with some new players around him, and he tried to do too much. He's got to try to let the game come to him tonight.
A true freshman will get it started here. Blake Pawbill to kick it away for Ohio State. Jeff Badette, one of the talented receivers, a transfer from Kentucky, number two, is back with Michael Jones. It's a short kick and returnable for Badette. Right up the middle, a little crease, and he's knocked down at the 28-yard line. The kicker got in there on the tackle, and here comes Baker Mayfield.
We just talked about how important it is for him to let the game come to him. 6'1", 220 pounds, one of the best players, not quarterbacks, players in college football. Poise on the road. He's got some young players around him. He's got to be able to keep his cool, especially early. Getting the ball out quickly against that pass rush from Ohio State. And then the ball placement, something we saw Richard Lego from Indiana have success on the back shoulder fade against young defensive backs. He can't just throw the ball. He's got to put it where his receiver has a chance to make a play on it away from a defender.
Abdul Adams is the back behind Mayfield, and then you see Dimitri Flowers, the fullback. Mayfield has a lot of freedom to do this. Change plays pre-snap. Fake and a throw over the middle, and Flowers out of the backfield makes the catch, kind of retreated, and he'll be tackled a yard short of a first down by Damon Webb.
Love the call. You've got Lincoln Riley. He knows he's on the road. Defense is excited in front of their home crowd. They get an aggressive defense out of position. A little delay, kind of a pop pass back to the tight end, his favorite target.
Flowers, a very experienced player, 40th career game. Now Adams has a little crease and a quick spurt out to the 45 for a first down. Chris Worley made the tackle. Here's our Chick-fil-A impact players, Kirk.
They're going tempo here. We'll try to squeeze this in real quick. When Oklahoma has the football, not only is it Baker Mayfield, but he's got a lot of players around him. Orlando Brown, the left tackle. Mark Andrews, 81. For Ohio State, Tremont Jones in the inside. And Denzel Ward, number 12, has got to be a leader out isolated one-on-one in coverage tonight.
Made a big pick in the opener against Indiana to seal things. Another quick throw, and it's batted down at the line of scrimmage. Tyquan Lewis, the senior who decided to come back for one more year in Columbus, made the play.
And that, you talked about getting the ball out quickly. Ohio State has that scouting report as well. And Tyquan Lewis, he knows he can't get in there, but the presence of mind to be able to time that up and knock that football down. Remember, that was an issue last year for Baker Mayfield against Ohio State. Jerome Baker ended up having a pick six. It was off a tip ball. Remember, he's listed at 6'1", but he's fairly short against that big D line.
And second down, Adams darts ahead. It'll be interesting to see how Greg Schiano calls the defensive pressures for trying to rattle a guy who's tough to rattle.
But it's very tough to rattle a guy who's played as many games. It's his 35th start. He's seen about every defense you can imagine. But you can try to affect the others around him with disguising coverages, disguising blitzes. Here's the first third down look. This is where Ohio State tries to really confuse the line and get after the quarterback.
Empty backfield. Adams, the tailback, is the far right of the formation. Buckeyes get him out of the pocket, but an accurate throw and a first down catch by C.D. Lamb, the talented true freshman.
Ohio State playing man-to-man and using Baker in the middle of the field as kind of a spy. When you play man-to-man, you're counting on your receivers to get separation. And the young true freshman, Lamb, does exactly that to get Baker Mayfield a chance at the first down.
He's out of Texas. They expect a big career. Now a direct snap, a little trickery as Adams takes it, and he rumbles forward down near first down yardage inside the 35.
That Oklahoma offensive line, we heard about that battle. How they going to do up front? Take a look and watch how they're doing. Cody Ford, 74. Nice job on a double team. They get a good push down block by Orlando Brown. And listen, Oklahoma recruits running backs. I know they don't have Samaje Perine or Joe Mixon, but they've got talent in that backfield that you'll see tonight.
So far, it's been all Abdul Adams. We expect a rotation of three Sooner backs. A frenetic start as the Sooners are using a lot of tempo. But Adams that time trapped in the backfield for a loss. Gracie Sprinkle, a big anchor in the middle of the senior, made the tackle.
It was a little bit of movement by Sprinkle. talked about what is Greg Schiano going to do. How's he going to come after them? Instead of coming here, he actually shoots around. I think creates a little bit of confusion up front. And that's what allowed him to shoot that gap fairly untouched and surprise the Oklahoma back, Abdul Adams.
So a third and four, they're in fringe field goal range.
And a man across.
Mayfield looks to the right and delivers a high throw, incomplete. Going up for it was Jeff Padet. The throw too high, and it's fourth down.
Interesting call, and he has the option to go to the inside routes or to go to the outside. It's a tough, long throw against Ohio State's best cover man.
Mayfield lobbying Kirk to go for it on fourth down, and I think he's won that one. They're going to go here. Lead four.
Kind of in that in-between area where you maybe too long for the field goal, and you don't want to punt it. Let's take a shot. When you have an experienced quarterback, you can do that.
Empty backfield again. Mayfield makes a downfield throw, incomplete. Tried to loop it to Lamb, but he was well covered by Kendall Sheffield, and the Buckeye defense holds.
This Ohio State secondary took some shots from some folks about people questioning how good they might be after Indiana threw the football with a lot of success in their first half. In most of those plays, they were in phase and good coverage. Indiana just made some plays tonight. They're off to a better start. Field has to do tonight with JT Barrett, by the way, another quarterback from Texas. Both these quarterbacks from the state of Texas start fast, throwing rhythm, and take advantage of the one-on-one opportunities.
He started very fast. J.K. Dobbins, the true freshman, who comes up, that 181-yard debut, a record-breaking debut for the true freshman out of LaGrange, Texas.
Yeah, he has incredible physical ability and great vision. You'll see that tonight.
Barrett keeps it and rolls and is pressured and just has to throw it into the bench. So third down quickly here.
Emmanuel Beal, guy who got some experience last year, playing with a lot more confidence, Mike Stoops tells us, coming out of camp. Closed in on JT Barrett, forced him to throw that ball away.
He's pumped up. He's the only Ohioan playing tonight for the Sooners. So on third down, Barrett from the pocket flips it short, and the catch is made, but short of first down yardage there. So Harris Campbell could not escape Johnson, and it's fourth down.
It was a mesh route, or just a crossing route underneath against man-to-man. And Will Johnson, as a safety in man coverage, does a really good job of avoiding contact from the other route coming across the field. Stayed on his man and kept the receiver, Harris Campbell, short of the first down.
So the Sooner defense, Kirk, got to a very slow start against UTEP. The Miners went 78 yards and 8 plays in the opening drive. Didn't do anything after that, but they get a 3 and a half to start this one.
And you always hear about tempo, and how great tempo is. Sometimes tempo can backfire on you as well. That was 3 plays in about 45 seconds, and you're off the field.
The Aussie, Cam Johnson's finally gone. So they have a freshman punter here, Drew Christman from Cincinnati, taking over, replacing one of the more effective punters that we've seen in college football.
On the offense, number 91, 5-yard penalty, fourth down.
It's a Big 12 crew tonight. Mike DeFee, he of the impressive biceps. Remember him from the championship game a couple of years ago?
Oh, absolutely. I told him. I saw him on the field before the game.
He's been doing the concentration curls this afternoon to get ready.
He said to let everybody know. He said, I want you to check the back of my shirt. And I did. Because everybody said he's wearing a medium. And I said, what do you got? And he goes, look at it. It's double XL. And I looked, confirmed, double XL.
That's research on your part.
He's just rocked up. He can't help it.
Here comes Christman. He boots it. Nice kick. Then pulls back and right near the sideline. He's going to make a fair catch as he goes out of bounds at the 9-yard line. So for their second possession after the 52-yard punt, Mayfield and company will be backed up.
Saturday Night Football on ABC is presented by Wells Fargo. Wells Fargo, building better every day. And in part by Nissan, innovation that excites.
Nissan Heisman House here in Columbus, including an appearance by Troy Smith, the winner in 06. This week's Nissan Heisman Watch takes a look at the opening game stats of Mayfield and Barrett, who figure to be in the conversation if their teams continue to do very well.
It's not a
one
bad start.
Baker only played a half.
I don't care if that's against air. Baker Mayfield, 19 to 20, pretty darn good.
And Barrett, after a slow start, got it cooking in the second half when the Buckeyes ran away from Indiana. Sooners ran off nine plays in the first position, made a couple of first downs, but begin from their own nine here. And a motion and a jet sweep look. And this is Jeff Bidette, a senior from Orlando, 3 years at Kentucky, made 28 starts, so he brings some experience to a little different offense.
Yeah, I mean, that might be considered a pass because he just barely tossed it to him, but it's essentially just a jet sweep. But they're stretching Ohio State, who is playing a lot of man-to-man, trying to get him outflanked, trying to stretch him sideline to sideline, and pretty effective there, picking up positive yards, 8 yards.
Oklahoma pointing across at the Buckeye front.
Draymond Jones.
Mike and company talking it over. A lot of talk back and forth about this matchup tonight.
Offside. Defense, number 86. In the neutral zone, causing the offense to react. 5 yard penalty. Yardage results in a first down.
Here's Draymond Jones, but you know, these guys have a lot of pride as college players, but Kirk, it's never too early to show what you got for the next level by going against future pros themselves.
Absolutely. Draymond Jones actually moving after the center, Eric Wren, looked through his legs, came back, and as he came back, Chris, the ball rotated, and I think that's what forced him to jump.
Maker. Play fake, fires far side, complete. And the catch is made by Lamb. Well, it's going to be interesting to see a true freshman as the featured receiver in this group.
And a rare moment where Ohio State goes soft in coverage. And when they go soft in coverage, there's Baker Mayfield's awareness. Dials it up, gets the ball to the outside, to Lamb. See Ohio State bailing in coverage there, Arnett falling back. And Baker Mayfield, instead of seeing a receiver, have to fight to his spot. Easy release, easy throw.
Again, direct snap to Adams, who fakes the pitch to Mayfield. They've run the play twice, and it's gained good yardage both times.
Yeah, just a counter play where they get the backside guard and the H-back pulling around. You see that little delay. Baker Mayfield hobbling off. Oh, boy.
He's kind of looking at his left leg.
You know, wow. What's weird, Chris, is he just carried out a fake there. I don't know if maybe in the previous play. He didn't even touch the football in that sequence.
Just a cramp, so in comes Kyler Murray, the transfer from Texas A&M, had to sit out last year, suddenly pressing the duty on second and four. And he hands the ball in the middle. Trey Sermon was the ball carrier. Buckeyes swarm, and it'll be third down, and Mayfield's going to trot back out now.
Yeah, it's good to see. I was surprised where he kind of limped off. By the way, Kyler Murray, he had 3 starts at Texas A&M. Highly touted kid back in 2015. Seems to be the guy next year to replace Baker Mayfield, so it's nice to have him there when they do get into a jam like that. But great to see six back out of the field for the Sooners.
Murray more of a runner than a polished thrower at this point. Sooners 1 for 2 so far in third down. Mayfield has room to run, stays in the pocket, and delivers a strike over the middle of first down. Again, it's Lamb, the guy the Buckeyes secondary is going to have to account for, clearly.
This is a great job by a young receiver to settle in to the soft spot of the zone. They rush 3, drop 8, and you don't want to run across. You need to just settle right in that soft spot. And for a young freshman, that's exactly what he did on third down.
He had a quiet opener against the Miners, but is already a huge factor tonight with 3 catches. Is Mayfield scrambling for his life? This is what he can do, is create incomplete. Kind of tightrope the sideline was Lamb, but you see why when number 6 has the ball, exciting things happen.
Yeah, you're exactly right. He never gives up on a play. That's what you got to love about him. They brought Chris Worley on a blitz. He shoots right through here, really affected the pass protection. Adams tries to get him, but you can just see the entire pocket collapses. Robert Landers is in there well, but instead of just panicking and throwing it away, keeps his cool, scrambles around. He has no idea where he's going to go. It's backyard football at that point, but at least he's able to throw it away to avoid a big loss.
Man really should have made that catch. Most guys would have just thrown it in the seats. Right. Baker. Second down from the Buckeyes 45. Mayfield keeps it, but he's trapped in the backfield by Sam Hubbard. Six tackles, six.
Now that's a misread by Baker Mayfield. I think he may have predetermined what to do with that. He's reading Sam Hubbard, and he's got to feel the energy with Hubbard. And is Hubbard going to stay out in the back? You keep it. But Hubbard acts like he's going to go to the back and then collapses down. So a misread by Baker. Now he's at third and long.
Adams in the slot. They need 12. Play clock at 5. Just get it off. Mayfield across the middle, and the catch is made by Mark Andrews, the tight end. He'll be stopped by Webb short of a first down.
You know, third and long like that makes you wonder if he's been, not only is Baker Mayfield, but Lincoln Riley thing, this four down territory. Let's pick up 7 or 8 or 9 yards and set up another opportunity to go for it on fourth down, just like their last series that they had. So they weren't necessarily looking as desperation mode. Let's force it down the field, throw the ball, let your big tight end make a play.
Once again, Riley not thinking about punting and putting him deep. Young guys clearly here to win and here to gamble. Here's Andrews in the slot. Lamb in motion. Mayfield running for his life. Looking for a man downfield. Lobs it to the end zone for Andrews over his head. A flag comes out. Damon Webb was in coverage. Buckeye crowd booing this call.
Get Dave Gataya in on this, but I really didn't see. There's contact both ways, but the big thing is the defensive back have his head turned where Damon Webb does not. They may talk about whether or not the ball was catchable.
Defense, number 7, 15-yard penalty.
Pretty good instincts.
That was one of his colleagues who threw him the ball.
Not only is he rocked up, but he's got the instincts.
Let's take a look at the replay.
I thought it might be an uncatchable ball. See, Damon Webb's head is not turned around. And that's probably as much as anything, Dave, why they might have got him with the interference.
Let's hear from Dave. Now we'll get his mic turned up.
Your head is not turned around and you make contact, they're going to get you on the pass interference.
Adams, a first down carry, loses the ball. Buckeyes say they have it. Chris Worley knocked it loose. And the Knights' first turnover. Jayshon Cornell came up with the football. And Ohio State once again makes a stand in its own territory.
And it's Chris Worley who's moved to that middle linebacker spot. Perfect form. Shoulder pad right on the football. Knocks that ball loose. And then Cornell, presence of mind there to pop, jump on top of the football to recover the turnover for Ohio State.
So twice Oklahoma has moved into Buckeye territory and come up empty, still scoreless, midway first quarter. 50s as this game progresses. Oklahoma's run 18 plays to 3 for Ohio State, but have come up empty in its 2 possessions. Now the Buckeyes take over after the fumble recovery at the 25. 3 and out the first time. J.K. Dobbins again in the back. We expect to see Mike Weber, the 1,000-yard rusher last year, who's been hampered by a hamstring that he injured in camp. Meyer expecting Weber and Dobbins to rotate tonight. Option look. And Barrett with the keeper. And a nice gain out across the 35 for a first down.
Well, there was some great blocking on this play by Ohio State. The right tackle does his job. The receiver in the slot do their job. Slow developing. Isaiah Prince gets to that second level, picks up a huge block to spring him loose.
Barrett play action now flushed from the pocket and again just throws it away. Urban telling Maria Taylor before the game to get one first down. Look out, we will crank the tempo. We're doing it already.
And Kevin Wilson telling us yesterday that that's a big part of what we want to do offensively. It's a big part of tempo. You always hear that. And gets defenses on their heels is getting that initial first down. And this time Ohio State not getting any separation with their passing game, with their receivers.
Dobbins lined up behind the quarterback. Now motions out on second and 10. They fake it to him. Barrett, good protection, and throws it underneath. It's complete to the tight end, Marcus Baugh. A flag is down.
They threw that right in the area with Motley and the young Ohio State receiver, Benjamin Victor. Up near the top of the screen.
Parnell Motley, first year starting corner, a sophomore.
Holding, defense, number 11. 10-yard penalty from the previous spot, automatic, first down.
And they moved the football into Oklahoma territory.
It kind of got tangled up, and Motley just grabbed a hold of him and threw him to the ground.
Talked about Kevin Wilson. What an amazing start to his career as the play caller here. Takes on Indiana in the opener. Of course, he was the head coach. And now takes on Oklahoma, where he was the play caller for Stoops before that. You couldn't draw up a more interesting schedule for Wilson here.
I mean, from here, it gets a lot easier emotionally, right?
Exactly.
At least Bob's not on the sideline, although he knows a lot of these assistant coaches. The guy that's calling the defense tonight, Mike Stoops, he's very good friends with and coached with him for a number of years.
First down. Barrett just has to dive down. The Sooners defense strung that one out. Nowhere to run. DJ Ward, the defensive end, was there. So was Thomas.
Bob Stoops is actually here. There with his wife.
With his daughter there.
His daughter.
Ohio native, so he's back in his home state.
Right.
Must be a strange feeling for him watching this game from above. We'll have a visit from him in the second quarter.
Yep.
Made his decision to retire in the summer. Barrett has a crease and darts near first down yardage inside the 45.
It's the same play they ran earlier for a first down. Ohio State, with a quarterback that can run the football, it makes the defense have to account for him getting their numbers up. Second time now we've seen that play work. Set up a very third and manageable short yardage here.
He ran it 13 times in the opener already. A few times tonight, and this is Dobbins, who's a quick guy with electric cutting ability, but also plenty of strength for a freshman. First down.
There are a lot of true freshmen that are going to get on the field, whether it's special teams or running the ball, or in Oklahoma's case, Kenneth Murray, who's playing the middle linebacker spot, number 9. You know, I mean, the game moves fast. Last week, Oklahoma played UTEP. Ohio State played Indiana. It's a whole different game tonight for those young players adjusting to the speed of the game.
They fake the pitch to Dobbins. Barrett is pressured and sacked back at midfield. Obo Okoronkwo, the sack man of that Oklahoma defense, and Beal, the Ohio native, got there.
Well, that was a matchup that Oklahoma felt very good about. Okoronkwo, because of what he can do in chasing a quarterback down, he's right here. He gives an outside move, then comes back to the inside, and against Isaiah Prince, he's worked so hard to improve his pass protection. The times that we do games last year where that was an issue for Ohio State on the right side, Okoronkwo that time goes right by him.
That matchup is going to be a problem if they leave Prince alone with old number 31. So both offenses making some headway, but the defense is coming up with enough to keep this a scoreless game so far. And I think that the Ohio State offense, which was kind of slow to get going against Indiana, there was that landslide of points after halftime. What have you seen so far from them as far, in terms of Meyer? A lot of quarterback runs, not the polish in the passing game that they made such an emphasis in the offseason.
Yeah, and I think for them against Mike Stoops' defense that's loaded up to try to stop the running game, they feel that the quarterback run game can kind of even the playing field a little bit in their running game. And eventually, if you become effective running JT Barrett, you're going to get some one-on-one opportunities. They're actually trying to hit a one-on-one play. That play? But Ohio State's pass protection, it's like a big puzzle on how you try to attack an Oklahoma defense. But I got to be honest, we're not a quarter into this game. If you're an Oklahoma fan, you're on the road in a tough environment with a young team, you got to be pretty proud of what they've done here in this first quarter and the kind of the attitude that they have played with, going for it on fourth down. I mean, they're here to compete. They're here to win this game.
I agree. You'd like to have some points, though, out of the first two drives, but I agree. They've shown a lot moxie early. This guy shows moxie. The freshman Dobbins is penned in, Kirk. Did you come off a 29-carry game in your opener? I know it's 9 days ago. That's a lot for a young back to come back from physically.
Yeah, and
it's not normal stuff.
No, it's not. It's not. But he's not a normal back. So
fair point.
You know, talking to him yesterday, I think he feels good coming in. But you're going to see Mike Weber tonight, maybe 10 to 12 carries as well. So he won't have to carry quite the load that he did last week.
But he has been a workhorse in this high-tempo attack for Ohio State in the first quarter. Third and 18. Barrett is pressured. Does a nice job stepping up and delivers incomplete. Threw it into coverage, and Will Johnson in a nice play to break it up. Harris Campbell was the intended receiver. Fourth down.
Yeah. Really good job by JT Barrett stepping up into the pocket to try to give himself some time. But still, even once he was in that pocket, he seemed unsettled and hesitant. It's because he's waiting and waiting and waiting for the receiver to eventually turn and try to separate away from Will Johnson. But Johnson, again, a guy that played nickelback, now playing safety, great eyes and getting around and knocked that ball away.
Now the senior from Baltimore knows a thing or two, and he won that one-on-one battle. So Chrisman will try to pin the Sooners deep. Gets the back spin. And the fair catch made at the 13-yard line. 2 minutes to go in the first quarter. Oklahoma's third possession. Once again, they have poor field position. Well, tomorrow morning at 9 a.m. on ESPN2, E60 is going to have a feature on Jake Olson, the young man that you feel like was a regular on College Game Day. Lost his sight, befriended Pete Carroll. Was a part of the USC program despite not having his sight, and got into a game, was a long snapper against Western Michigan. Just an amazing young guy, and you'll enjoy this long form feature on E60 tomorrow morning.
Yeah, we played a portion of that with Shelly Smith this morning, and because you and I and anybody associated with Game Day first met him a few years ago, it was bring a tear to your eye watching his story, and to be able to see it now, there he is at his dream school, the school that he's always admired, and snapping for him, get that opportunity.
This is Trey Sermon, part of a tailback rotation for Oklahoma, his second carry tonight in his short first down game.
You know, Bob Stoops, you talked about it, must be strange watching Lincoln Riley, but Lincoln Riley has some of the same DNA as far as that aggressive nature as a head coach. And Bob Stoops, that's how he built his reputation, going for it on fourth down and taking some risks. He's got to be happy to see that from Lincoln Riley here early.
Play fake, Mayfield across the middle, wide open. His Flowers running free, and he's got a first down across the 35. Riley was a spotted by Bob Stoops. He was a Mike Leach kind of protege initially.
Absolutely. Right here, slips out Chris, and he's probably as comfortable throwing to Flowers as he is throwing to Andrews. Those are his two guys tonight, 81 and 36, when he's on the road in this kind of environment. In sync with both of them. Great job of feeling that by Flowers to find that area between a safety and a linebacker.
Flowers played a lot of football. Finally got his first career touchdown against UTEP last week. That had to feel real good. Sermon making some nice cuts in the middle as the Buckeyes try to rip at the football. Stopped at the 38.
I would put Dimitri Flowers in the discussion of one of the most underappreciated or undervalued college football players in the country. He's a senior. He's 6'2", about 245 pounds. He's an H-back. He can be a tight end. If the tailbacks get beat up like last year against Iowa State, it can put him back there to let him run as a tailback. Guy does so much, and to be a senior, he's kind of part of the glue along with Baker Mayfield and Mark Andrews.
He's full on Sundays as well.
Yes. Oh, yeah.
And second down, final 30 seconds of the half. This is Andrews. He's kind of a bubble screen, and he rumbles into Ohio State territory. See if the Sooners try to squeeze in another play for the end of the first quarter. Got 14 that time.
Yeah, like a little jailbreak screen. And when you run that, it has to be timed up perfectly, especially against the Ohio State speed. And time the patience on the route and the patience on Baker Mayfield, kind of looking it off, looking to his right, and then coming back to it, opened it up for a big gain.
So a first quarter scoreless in Columbus, where the Sooners run double the number of plays and outgain Ohio State 119 to 25. Back at the Horseshoe after this message and a word from your local ABC station. Welcome back to Saturday Night Football, presented by Wells Fargo, in this presentation of the Big Ten on ABC. Sooners involved in a scoreless first quarter for the first time in 4 years. Not that unusual for Ohio State.
No, and Ohio State, you know, they got off to a slow start against Indiana. Slow start tonight. Oklahoma, we've talked a lot in this broadcast, 119 yards to Ohio State's 25. They've been much more aggressive.
All three possessions, they've reached Ohio State territory now. Mayfield gets it out very quick. The ball bobbled by Badette. That was very close to a backwards pass. Damon Webb comes up with the football.
That's exactly right, Chris. Yeah, that's exactly right. Is it a backwards pass? We know he didn't catch it.
The receiver never had possession of the football.
Yeah, I don't think it's an issue about having possession. I think it's a lateral. Chris, you're all over it there at the beginning.
Yeah, he never came up with it, but if it's a lateral, that's a fumble. And Webb did make a pretty quick recovery to bring in Dave Kataya.
You guys are absolutely right. To me, in this angle, that's a backward pass, and I don't care about possession. The ball is loose. Here we have an immediate recovery in the continuing action. So if they reverse this, which I believe they should, you're not going to get an advance, but the team recovering is going to get the ball.
Mike DeFee has gone down to the headphone here. He'll talk to the replay official, Don Campbell.
Watch where he's standing. He's at about, what was it, about the 47-yard line? Looks like where he throws the ball, he's standing at about maybe the 48-yard line. He's throwing from the 48, and he tries to catch it at the 49.
There's a sideways look. It's difficult to say with certainty that it was backward. It looked like we watched it live, that it did not go. This will be better.
And I love how Baker Mayfield tried to sell it by dropping. His body actually fell back after he threw it.
There's another look at
He's at about the 48.
It's not where his body is, where the ball comes out of his hand.
Yeah.
And that is about as close as you can get. This Big 12 crew is conferring with the Big 12 replay crew. They all travel together. The same group staying together, all 12 of them throughout the season.
So, Dave, you're saying, regardless, you said this is a lateral in your mind based on these replays?
Well, in the first replay, yes, but Chris is exactly right. It's not where his feet are, it's where the ball is released from. That last shot makes it very, very close, okay? It appears backward to me, but then again, they have to be 100% sure to reverse this call.
They have a monitor. Now, really, it's not DeFee. It's Capro, the replay official, that has the final say here, but DeFee can offer some input. See if they feel there's enough to overturn the call on the field of incomplete.
After review, the pass was actually backwards. It was recovered by Ohio State at the 49-yard line, first down.
So a second Oklahoma turnover as Webb comes up with the fumble recovery from Badette.
And I think that is confusing, the body versus the arm and where he is. And as I said, Baker Mayfield falls back after he throws the ball. And that when you watch where the ball is thrown, that's by a half a yard
maybe,
or less.
Maybe.
Yeah, it's tight.
I did not think they were going to see enough there to overturn it, but they do. And Ohio State, much needed boost for an offense that has struggled. They begin at the Sooner 49.
And Ohio State hit Oklahoma for a lot of vertical passes last year, 4 touchdown passes. Not taking a shot yet. See, with a sudden change, and Mike Samuel now in the lineup for J.K. Dobbins.
And Mike Weber checks in, his first action of the season. Hamstring finally ready to go. Remember, 1,000-yard rusher, a freshman All-American last year. He's got the football. And Weber sprinting inside the 40. He looks healthy finally.
Had a hamstring when he went into camp. Tweaked it about 10 days ago and had to miss the opener. This is just good blocking to get him outside. Paris Campbell picks up a good block. You can also see Terry McLaurin. And yeah, you're right. After the night or the week that J.K. Dobbins had last week, you got to be thinking Mike Weber's been waiting to get his hands on the ball.
They fake it to a missed time. Barrett steps up, and now he'll take off, and he is hit hard by Caleb Kelly, the linebacker. But it's enough to move the sticks.
It's the first time we've called Caleb Kelly's name. Sophomore out of Fresno, 5-star, who played last year and really got some experience. They're turning to him now to become one of the leaders of the defense.
Imagine being Mike Weber. You're over there. You can't quite go, and you're watching J.K. Dobbins fill in and look like a young Barry Sanders. You better get healthy quickly. You want to get back in the rotation. Play fake. Barrett has a lot of time. Takes it outfield, shot looping for the end zone, just incomplete. And that was McLaurin running by Jordan Thomas.
He got him isolated one-on-one, actually got some separation. And I don't know if Thomas got a hand on the ball or if it just goes through the hands of McLaurin. Let's take a really close look at the end there. I don't think he touched it.
They had a 300-yard passing game, Kirk, against Indiana. But as you said, that's misleading. They didn't have the kind of downfield success. In fact, they were 0-for-9 when the ball was thrown 15-plus yards downfield in that game. So still looking to connect. This is what Barrett does very well, though. Takes off and will be knocked down after a short game. By the way, on the Oklahoma sideline, Kirk, there is concern for one of their key weapons. That is Mark Andrews, the tight end. And he is, as you said, one of the key guys for Mayfield, and an obvious pain with that left knee.
He's one of the more experienced guys, along with Dimitri Flowers. You can see the pain he's dealing with there. 6'5", 254 pounds.
See if we can get some information from Maria on that. But that didn't look good preliminarily. Ohio State needs 8 to try to keep the drive going here and cash in the takeaway. Play clock winding down. Meyer wants him to snap it quickly. And Barrett just gets it off. Hand off. Weber bursts into the secondary, and it's a first down near the 20. He looks like a guy that's been pent up and ready to run, although he comes up limping a bit after that carry.
How about they read the big guy, Matt Romar, right here, and then they double team right here, and it just opens up. They don't even block the guy over the left guard. Double team. No one's there. It's third and long. Three receivers to the left. All the focus out there. They end up running a read option into the middle.
So Dobbins takes over from Weber. They fake it to him. Barrett flips it on the edge. And the catch is made by K.J. Hill, who's still running down inside the 10. Tough running from the sophomore from Little Rock.
Follow it up with another read option. And J.T. Barrett masterful these last two plays. The one he ends up giving, this time he pulls. And instead of running, it's almost like a pitch. But instead, you see quarterbacks now throwing the football to the outside. And K.J. Hill makes something happen after the catch.
Yeah, back-to-back 13-yard gain. Sets up a first and goal. He is such a good ball handler and faker, isn't he? Barrett fakes it again, but that time a play made in the backfield by Okoronkwo, his second big play tonight.
That's what speed can do for you. Okoronkwo at 6'1", 240. The right guard, Brandon Bowen, trying to get out there, 76. Watch how he tries to get out there, but see that quickness, that suddenness, the vision for Okoronkwo, that's what allows him to make that play out on the edge of the defense.
One of the captains on this Oklahoma team. So second and goal. Back from the 12-yard line. Barrett from the pocket. Has time. Still looking. Fires across the middle, incomplete. It's a low throw. He comes across his body trying to get it to Austin Mack. Third and goal.
Got to give Oklahoma credit for the coverage. J.T. Barrett doing his best to keep that play alive, but the secondary had good coverage downfield, and Gallimore, 90 for a big guy, chasing down J.T. Barrett. He's 310 pounds trying to chase J.T. Barrett down.
Barrett just 2 for 7, and one was a pop pass.
I mean, they've got size down in this area with Benjamin Victor.
Weber is back in the game. Obviously okay, and they motion him out. Sooners rush 5. Complete over the middle. Hard hit. Campbell knocked down at the 5 immediately by Will Johnson, and it's fourth down. Will Johnson on the stop. Offense still on the field for the moment, and now Meyer says he'll take the 3.
Gain to the 6-yard line, fourth and goal of Ohio State.
The Buckeyes reach the red zone, but the Sooners make a stand there. Sean Nurnberger, field goal kicker 3 years ago, who was beaten out each of the last 2 years by a graduate transfer, comes back to reclaim the job. 18 for 26 in his career. This one from just 24.
And so Ohio State moves it from midfield and settles for three after the Sooners' second turnover. 3-0. Did a defensive battle there. Auburn with the answers until that touchdown drive. Keep you posted on that one. Ohio State striking first. 43 yards and 10 plays after recovering that fumble backward pass. This is what the Buckeyes do in kickoff. They did it last year. It's an Urban Meyer specialty. Left hash, try to kick it down the left corner and pin the returner in one part of the field. Boots it. And the Death, who just had the fumble, tries for redemption at the five and has a little room. Bounce off a blocker. Nice return out near the 30-yard line. Maria Taylor down there on the Oklahoma sidelines. What do you see so far, Maria?
Well, right now, Chris, a big concern for Oklahoma. Mark Andrews, a big target for Baker Mayfield. They were getting his left knee checked out by the athletic training staff, and he got up and was trying to put weight on it, but he was never able to put his full weight on that left leg. He also tried to plant and just kind of shook his head a little bit. A lot of players and coaches coming up to him asking him how he's doing, and he's yet to pick his helmet back up yet here on the sideline, guys.
Well, thank you. When the foot is planted and then he takes a shot from the side, never a good thing. So now you have an all-conference guy with 15 career touchdowns, replaced by a true freshman, Kirk, Grant Calcaterra.
6'3", 232-pound true freshman, highly touted. Actually was in the spring, which helps him be ready for this. We'll see how he can hold up. That's a big loss if Andrews cannot come back.
Had a couple catches in the opener against Utah, but you're right, exactly. He's one of Mayfield's trusted weapons.
We'd probably have to turn more now to Dimitri Flowers, 36.
Sermon is the back. Mayfield still got the ball and running out of time, and he'll be sacked. Sam Hubbard again got to the quarterback, his second sack tonight.
Now this defensive line is known for its versatility. They all bring something a little bit different to the table, and Sam Hubbard is known because he is a relentless pass rusher here, kind of protecting his edge. But then he sees Baker Mayfield in scramble mode, and that's where he doesn't give up on the play. Eventually that effort pays off for him.
And Mayfield was limping just a bit again after that play. Went out earlier for one play and doesn't appear too stable on his feet as he waits for the snap on second and 14. Fake it to Sermon. Bidette in the clear. And Bidette has room and a downfield block, and he scoots all the way to Ohio State territory. And Mayfield is limping as he trots up.
You better get out there when you're a man to man. And Damon Arnett not out there quick enough. Here comes Bidette. The ball almost actually hits him. They get the ball out to him fast, and it's just man to man. Arnett followed him from the right all the way over to the left. And when you're playing man to man and you beat your guy, everybody else has their back turned, and there's room to run.
Biggest play of the night, 29 yards. Left to keep a close eye on Mayfield's mobility. It's a big part of his effectiveness, and he is not 100% right now. Tried to trot downfield so they could play up tempo, but he was limping. Rolling. Chased. And just throws it in the bench. Gets a bump out of bounds. Jalen Holmes was there in a hurry. Part of that great defensive line, the four rushmen. It's almost unfair to put four defensive ends that good on the field.
No doubt. You put Draymond Jones on there, even though he plays tackle. He's basically athletic as a defensive end, but you're right. We want to keep a close eye on Baker Mayfield. Even there, scrambling after he threw the ball away, I followed him into the sideline. You could see kind of favoring. I can't tell if it's a, we don't want to speculate, but it looks like he's favoring something on that right side.
Buckeye shows some pressure immediately, flipped over the middle, and it is Dimitri Flowers. The big H-back makes another catch and rumbles down to the 25 before Worley stopped him.
What a call by Lincoln Riley. Man-to-man right here, and he's lined up with him because of the blitz and the delay. Watch 36 kind of get lost, and then he slips out. Just a little bit of a slight delay, almost like a slip screen. But I think Chris Worley got caught with his eyes in the backfield wondering if Baker Mayfield might be taking off, and he lost his eyes on his man, and it freed him up.
Even hobbled a bit. Mayfield picking up yardage in chunks. They got 20 that time. Retreating, rolling, and he's got enough in those wheels to scamper for a nice gain. See where they spot him. I thought he was getting closer to the 20. They're going to put the ball to 23.
You know, last year, he and Lincoln Riley talked about how he was pressing. He was trying to make too many things happen. He looks like a different guy going through this again, dealing with the pressure, finishing third in the Heisman. He's just a grizzled veteran. And right now, with a lot of new personnel around him at wide receiver and running back, his poise, which is a big aspect of tonight, is being put on display.
Ball spotted at the 22 now. Mayfield across the middle, threw it behind Calcaterra, the freshman tight end, filling in for Andrews.
Yeah, they got Ohio State right now on their heels. They're pushing the right buttons. The play is there. And I know we talked about Andrews being out. Calcaterra, you don't want to give up on him. This ball's thrown behind, but that's a catch. The only thing he did is he peeked down to see where
that, didn't he?
Yeah, he started to see if he was going to get hit. But if he holds on to that ball, it's at least a first down and probably a touchdown.
So you see the impact of the veteran not being in there right away. Mayfield needs six on third down. Buckeyes bring pressure, and Sermon tries to squirt free. He's tackled a few yards short by Nick Bosa. And Riley again, this time is going to send out the field goal team.
Yeah, I mean, we've seen him go for it twice. It was a lot further out. He's much closer to give his kicker a much better chance of trying to tie this game up.
And his kicker is a veteran. Austin Seibert does the punting and kicking. Did not attempt a field goal in the blowout over UTEP. For his career, he's 29 of 39. He's from 37 to tie the ball game. And the timing was messed up. The snap not cleanly handled by Connor McGinnis, the holder. And the kick is wide right. And another nice drive by Oklahoma results in no points.
That's as much on the snap as it is the hold. And the snap is low. Hunter does the holder does the best job that he can of trying to get that ball down.
But again, Oklahoma gained a bunch of yards, but no points yet.
Saturday Night Football on ABC, presented by Wells Fargo, is brought to you by Pacific Life. Experience the power of Pacific. And Chevy, the only brand to earn J.D. Power Dependability Awards for cars, trucks, and SUVs 2 years in a row.
Buckeyes take over up three midway second quarter. See the retired numbers. I don't see a four up there, but that's got to be rectified very soon.
Oh, yeah. Oh, absolutely. Some big names up there.
Oklahoma's moved the ball every time. A turnover, a fourth down stop, and now a missed field goal, and they have come up empty. So Barrett, another first down carry. This is a treat. Bob Stoops, after 18 years as the boss of Oklahoma, back in your home state, what has to be an absolutely surreal experience to look at a game that you're not involved in coaching from up here.
No, I've said it a few times today. It's like I'm in the Twilight Zone, you know, so it is very surreal, but all good. Proud of the team. They're playing hard, playing well. Lincoln's doing a great job.
It reminded me a little bit of you in your younger days. Fourth down plus territory. I mean, both times they're pressing. They're going for it. They're on the road. Tough environment. They're here to win.
Absolutely. And I agree with them. 35-yard line. Yeah. You have to do that. Lincoln's doing a great job calling a great game. We've been close to popping a few big plays and have, but got to take care of the ball and finish.
In terms of road openers as a head coach, a guy that just turned 34, this is a pretty interesting challenge for a guy that you feel has the goods to be a great head coach. Sooners trying to get off the field here on defense, but Barrett's going to scramble for another first down, still running out across the 40.
Now Lincoln's he's wise beyond his years. You know, even though he's only 34, he's had great experience that's put him in great position to handle this.
You ever feel like texting something down or like getting a message? You've been doing this for so long. This is your boy. These are your boys.
I did place a call earlier. My wife, my daughter, and wife were laughing at me, so no one answered on on the other end.
Dobbins makes the catch, but the Sooner defense up to stop him. Oklahoma has had such a great history of being a road team. Talking to Baker Mayfield about that this week. Your teams are known for being able to come into an environment like this and deal with it. What do you see in this group that, that makes you feel they're ready for this challenge tonight?
Well, they're playing really well. You know, we've just really it's just a couple of turnovers, you know, taking care of the football. But these guys have been in big games, all these guys. You know, we're Oklahoma. We're used to that. Every year we have big non-conference games. This is just another one.
Boy, Mike's defense so far, I mean, we've still got another 2.5 quarters to go, but really impressive with the way they played tonight, playing with a little bit of an edge and attitude.
We're playing sharp, smart. You could tell, you know, they're going to make some plays, but they're doing a really good job.
Ohio State needs 9 on this play. And Barrett has time in the pocket, but now it collapses, and he's thrown down by Okoronkwo, who again imposes himself against that Ohio State offensive line.
We talked about that matchup with Okoronkwo because of how athletic he is against Isaiah Prince. Right out here, surprised that Ohio State leaves him one-on-one on third down. Spin move, doesn't give up on it. JT Barrett waiting for separation, and it's Isaiah Prince at that right tackle spot.
You know this guy, Bob?
Yeah, Mike's playing with him.
That's the body English.
I got to admit, I was doing the same thing in the box next to him. So when I'm on the field, I don't need to do it as much. But in the box, you do. It seems like you're helping him.
They force a punt, and it's Adet mishandles it, but falls on it. Bob, I wish you a tremendous retirement in the Twilight Zone. Thanks for your time. All former coaches end up here at some point. So we'll see you.
Well, maybe. Thank you, Chris.
Thanks, all right, man.
Sooners go back on offense, down by 3. Partner of the College Football Playoff. You can be on the lookout for Taco Bell student sections and crazy fans like these at games all season long. They've been preparing since before game day this morning. They've not seen a bunch of offensive fireworks yet, especially not from the home team.
87 yards, Chris, at this point for Ohio State's offense.
There was a kick catch interference on that fair catch, so a 15-yard penalty, and Ohio State moves it to the 28 to start this Sooner possession. Mayfield flips it short, and the catch is made by Sermon out of the backfield for a 9-yard gain.
Well, what they're doing back there, because they have a veteran quarterback, a guy they trust, they're just giving Ohio State's linebackers and safeties a lot of different looks, whether it's the motions or it's a cross action where you fake up the middle that time to Anderson, then you get the young freshman out in the flat. You can see Ohio State just kind of waiting, hesitant, and not real sure where the ball is.
It was a two-back look, and this is Rodney Anderson motioning out, makes the catch, makes a nice cut, and is out near midfield for a first down. Chris Brewley made the tackle. They're using the backs as receivers a bunch.
Well, they have to, and the other thing that they've done is they've, oh, there's Baker Mayfield hobbling off again. And that's where Kyler Murray's got to come in and play some real football tonight.
Injuries beginning to mount to Oklahoma, and you couldn't pick worse players to be hampered with. Andrews apparently out. Mayfield is hobbled. And now the talented runner, the sophomore Murray, comes in. And the first down pitch, they get it back. And Murray, he showed you the acceleration and the speed. He brings an element.
It's a different gear when he gets the ball. How about the play call, by the way? Backup quarterback comes in, first play, he gets a chance to be able to run. How about a handoff, pitch back to the backup quarterback, and let him get to the corner? I just talked about how they're giving a lot of different looks. This is a different look and a different gear from Murray, who gets to the corner and picks up 9 in a hurry.
You see number 4 pitching, it's like shades of Jamel Holloway back in the day.
That's a
different kind of option look. Mayfield's back. He's been in and out a couple times now. Second and 1 play. Mayfield's going to keep it. He's healthy enough to run the football, and they move the 6 to the 40.
You know, it's funny when he comes back from being taken off the field, and he looks like there's nothing wrong.
And they run it, a design run.
Right.
Andrews with the ice on the knee. Oklahoma, Kirk, for the 5th time in 5 drives. They've crossed midfield. They've threatened consistently. Just not been able to convert. Sermon slips free. He shows some power. He's not really considered one of the main backs in the rotation, but he is tonight.
No, I think they're still trying to find their way with the loss of Joe Mixon and Samaje Perine. They've got a committee there. We've seen mostly Abdul Adams. We've seen a little bit of Rodney Anderson and Trey Sermon, the true freshman. Powerful back for a freshman at 225 pounds. Playing with a little bit of emotion tonight, too, for a young guy. He's probably been thinking about this opportunity and this kind of stage his whole life.
He got nine on second down. He's got it again. Boom, slams forward for a first down at the 25. About 2.5 to go before halftime.
And these college coaches that are coaching at the elite level, when they bring in true freshmen, they're looking to play them. It's not about redshirting. They're looking to play them. And so what you have to do if you come in for spring, you try to get them acclimated, which Sermon had a chance to be in for spring, and you get them in against that first-team defense, and you try to give them a feel of what fast defense is all about. So when they get into a game like this, they're ready to play at game speed.
They feel a first down shot for the end zone. Loop down there. Battle for the ball incomplete. Jeffrey Meade was very well defended. Denzel Ward on coverage.
As soon as he threw the ball, Jerome Baker, 17, is going to lower the boom right there.
Wow.
And ball is pretty good coverage by Denzel Ward trying to use the sideline.
Baker, the guy that had the big pick six against Mayfield last year, delivering a hard shot. Rodney Anderson is now the back. He gets a turn. Anderson bursts free. Well, you see those other guys running well. If you get an opportunity like Anderson did, you want to make something of it. He got about eight.
He absolutely did. And we've talked about this battle up front. How is it going to go? Watch the right tackle, Bobby Evans, against Tremont Jones. Puts him on his back. You want to watch old school football? Watch this Oklahoma veteran offensive line against the talented Buckeye defensive line. There's some wars going on up front.
You see Bosa get knocked sideways?
Yeah.
Cody Ford as a backup came around.
Absolutely. 74.
Focus on the trenches on this third and two. Play clock at one, and now they'll have to spend a timeout to talk about this crucial play. Minute 20 to go before halftime. Riley's offense has moved it all over the place, come up empty so far. See if that changes before halftime. For championship drive game of the week, Baker Mayfield's limped off a couple times. He just got rocked on a big hit from Jerome Baker. He had the back worked on by one of the athletic trainers in the timeout. But he's trying to get at least 2 yards, get Oklahoma closer to the end zone here. Rodney Anderson is the back. Sooners have misfired when they've moved the ball into Ohio State territory so far in this half. 2 for 5 on third downs.
Looking over to get confirmation, sees man to man. Lincoln Riley's just, he's going to wait, calls another timeout.
But you don't have Andrews in the game. He's obviously appears to be done for the night. Dimitri Flowers wasn't in the game that time.
Actually, they put him up where Anderson is lined. They took that. That's when we talked about the versatility of Flowers.
Oh, was he moved up on the line that
time?
Yeah,
he moved up. He's playing. That tells you about him.
You better spot him.
No, I'll play tight end.
Yeah.
I'll play tight end. No problem.
Chris Felica, the Bear, will wedge in the Affleck trivia question tonight while the Sooners talk about it. Bear.
What's going on, guys?
Hey, big fella, what do you got?
Time for tonight's Affleck trivia question. Of course, 40th anniversary of the famous Uwe Von Schaumann game-winning field goal. So much talk about the quarterbacks in this game. Who were the starting quarterbacks that night in 1977?
I got one of them.
I'm going to go Rod Gerald wearing 8.
I'm going to go with Thomas Lock for
wearing,
Oklahoma.
Yeah, wearing OU. That's my guess.
I'm pretty sure about the Oklahoma side. Lott got injured here at an ankle after the Sooners led 20 to nothing in that game.
We're going to answer that athletic trivia question for you right now because you both are correct. You got the ball. And you're exactly right. Lott got hurt.
We shared that one.
I got Thomas Lott.
And Dean Blevins came in and led the Sooners to the comeback win.
Dean Blevins. That's right. It's in broadcasting. We have Billy Sims went out of that game.
That was a great classic game.
Switzer said, we're on the way to putting half 100 on them.
and then our guys got hurt, and they had to rely on a kick to win it.
Yeah, Rod Gerald was a bad man, too.
No, they don't want to have to kick here. Oklahoma would love to claim the lead. They'll feel like they were the better team in this first half. Don't have the lead to show for it yet. A lot of talk about this third down play. Let's see what they came up with. Mayfield from the pocket. A lot of time. Now backpedals. Escapes. And is going to be knocked down just short of the marker. Jalen Holmes chased him down, and now a decision as the clock runs 105 before halftime.
You know, Ohio State, they didn't even try to get upfield. They just tried to squeeze him in the pocket and not allow him to get out. And then, as you say, another big decision.
This time they're going to take the three. Yep. Yeah, they need about a yard and a half. And I think the feeling, Kirk, you've done all this work. You outgained Ohio State by more than 2-1. If you don't have any points,
they don't have a point.
Yeah, I think that's behind this decision. Seibert was wide right after the blow snap the first time. You got to hurry if they're going to get it off. They just do, and this time he knocks it right through. So it takes until the final 25 seconds of the first half for Oklahoma to get on the board and tie the game at 3 as we check in with Cassidy Hubbard. Georgia fans so excited to be playing in South Bend. I think they invaded in huge numbers. Way more people went up than had tickets, right?
Oh, yeah. I mean, they would love to fill the entire stadium if they could.
Notre Dame fans wouldn't quite let that happen.
No, I remember one year you and I, in game day, we went up to a Nebraska Notre Dame game, and a sea of red came into South Bend that day.
We saw Mayfield, who's 11 of 18 in the first half. There's Barrett, who's had a frustrating day throwing the ball. Again, shades of last week. But Baker has been hobbled. He's been banged up. He took that shot from Jerome Baker. He's knocked off his feet. That's a bigger concern than the leg, I think, at this point.
I'll tell you what, it's going to take a lot for Six to come out of the game. He is as competitive as a guy as there is in the country.
But he's a guy that has fun. There's a lot of joy in his game. I don't think he's having a lot of fun now because he's just trying to manage himself physically. Hill and Campbell back deep to receive the kick. And this is Campbell who will leave it right there. 1977, Oklahoma's come from behind victory right here 40 years ago.
First meeting in history between these two great football teams with 6 seconds to play. 41-yard field goal to win it. It is good. Wow. Ladies and gentlemen, I don't believe you can watch a more exciting football game anywhere.
Uwe Detlef Walker von Schaman from 41 yards to win it. That was a heck of a comeback. They had to score a touchdown, went for two, didn't get it, got the onside kick to get the ball back to get in position. And that was a thriller. That was the last visit by Oklahoma here. You can hope for some fireworks in the second half to equal that one. It's 24 seconds, and this is Dobbins. He's dangerous anytime he touches it. Hey, listen, man, we both grew up listening to the games like that.
Absolutely.
So that'll be it. Ohio State's offense doesn't do a whole lot. 91 yards in the BMW halftime report with Kevin Negandhi, Mac Brown, and Booger McFarland is coming up. Scores and highlights from a busy day and analysis from this one as Mayfield slowly makes his way. Oklahoma, 222 yards, ran off a dozen more plays, got in Ohio State territory 5 times. But for a variety of reasons, it is just 3-3. Down to Maria.
All right, Coach, under 100 yards of total offense. How would you assess that side of the ball?
Yeah, it's terrible. We got to play much better, and our defense is hanging in there. A couple turnovers, that's terrible.
Well, how do you change that around in the second half?
Go meet on it right now.
Okay, right. Thanks, Coach.
Not mincing words. Terrible, in a word, Meyer and his offensive performance in the first half. But it is 3-3 into the first half in Columbus. The BMW halftime report right after these messages. Welcome back to Saturday Night Football, presented by Wells Fargo, and this presentation of the Big Ten on ABC. Sooners of the Buckeyes deadlocked at 3. An interesting first half. Last year's meeting, 52 points scored in the first half, 35 by Ohio State. It was kind of a first half knockout in Norman. This is very different, and Ohio State's going to get the ball, Kirk, to begin the third quarter here, trying to solve some things on offense. Urban Meyer said terrible. That's how he described the offense.
That was his quote, and I think he's frustrated just because he's unable to see his offense be able to get down inside Oklahoma territory and come away with points. Just, again, they're not able to find a rhythm with a balanced attack, running and throwing. And so far, we've seen JT Barrett just 5 of 11 for 25 yards throwing the football.
Ball is going to be brought out. This is a nice return here. Paris Campbell can fly, blazing speed, kicker across to cut him off, and just does save a touchdown. Paris Campbell, electric speed.
Boy, he does a good job of setting up the blocks as if he's going up the middle, and then he just follows a couple of blockers right there, and now he's out in the open field. And as you said, Chris, he's got a lot of speed when he gets out there. We saw that last week against Indiana when he just ran away from the Indiana defense, and Ohio State starts their first drive of the second half in Oklahoma territory.
It took a short pass, raced 74 yards to the end zone to break that open. 56 yards on this kickoff return.
You'll see Ohio State try to be much more aggressive with their play calling.
That woke up the horseshoe. There's a buzz finally here. And Barrett rolls as Chase delivers complete on the far side. McLaurin trying to escape and finally knocked down inside the 40.
You know, you saw Oklahoma with what I thought a much more aggressive approach with Lincoln Riley, taking that us against the world. We're going on the road, a tough environment. We're going to take some swings. And I think you're going to see Ohio State, if they're going to win this game, they're going to have a similar approach, where instead of being, you know, a little bit more conservative, they've got to be more aggressive.
Dobbins, who was held in check in the first half, makes a little stutter step and a nice cut. He is a high-energy player. First down inside the 25.
They don't block DJ Ward. They actually read him right here. They're not going to touch him. 16's responsible for him. He stays wide. He takes the quarterback. He hands the ball off, and the others are blocking for big yards.
McLaurin in motion. This is Dobbins. You don't want to hype a kid after one game, but the skill set is reminiscent of a Reggie Bush.
Well, I think you got to remember, he's a true freshman, but he's much more powerfully built as a true freshman than Reggie Bush, especially his lower body. But he's got a burst like that.
Barrett keeps it, and he's knocked down after a short gain.
Ohio State, they did the same thing last week against Indiana. Urban Meyer took Kevin Wilson, Ryan Day, the offensive staff, in and said, listen, we've got to make JT Barrett more a part of the running game because it sets up other aspects of our offense, like the play action pass.
He is on the run, and catch is made on the edge by Benjamin Victor. First time he's gotten involved, and Ohio State another first down.
Ohio State early in the year still trying to find that go-to guy. They feel they have 6, but at some point you get into games like this, who's he going to turn to make that play?
He wanted to throw to Dobbins out of the backfield. He was well covered. JT Biden his time, tucks it, and slides down at the 6. Already he's run the ball 12 times tonight.
And again, there's the tempo. He's already ready to snap the ball again. And what they're doing right now, that's a rush 3, drop 8, and a great answer by JT Barrett.
Caronquo down on the ground. He always, hey, these are modern times. You get a little suspicious when a defensive player goes to the ground. Try to slow the tempo, but you certainly hope there's no injury there. Oklahoma has had some key guys already nicked up, and he's their best defensive player. Oh boy.
Yeah, Chris, you always do wonder about this with players there. When they watch 31, you see him right in the middle and he just kind of goes down.
Now he may have felt something. I'm not calling him dishonest, but it is a frequent tactic these days.
It is, and it's not against the rules. It's considered unethical. but it's not against the rules.
But he's not the guy you want to fall down.
No.
You pick somebody else to trot out there.
Yeah, and again, we don't know if he had a cramp or if he had something, but he was standing there fine and then looked over and kind of went down.
You talk about tempo. They cranked it to a new level in this possession.
That's what I said. They're going to have to get more aggressive. And part of being aggressive, this isn't the play call. It's the tempo that Urban Meyer likes to go with.
Dobbins lined up behind Barrett on second and two. Freshman's got it. And he's got a touchdown. Finally, Ohio State finds the end zone. First possession of the second half.
It goes back to the kickoff return to give them great field position. Watch the block by Michael Jordan. Helps on the double team and then climbs to the freshman linebacker, Kenneth Murray. Chip gets up, and there's the size. And now J.K. Dobbins can kind of sneak behind those big linemen, most of which are 6'7".
Did everything last week in his debut but score a touchdown. And now the first of what figures to be many touchdowns in the Buckeye career of J.K. Dobbins out of LaGrange, Texas. Right up the middle as the Buckeyes move it 44 yards after Paris Campbell's kickoff return up by a touchdown.
Welcome back to Dr. Pepper Championship Drive Game of the Week.
Well, the Campbell kickoff return to begin the second half got this place jumping, and then Ohio State moving it 44 yards. First career touchdown for J.K. Dobbins. And now Baker Mayfield minus his tight end, Andrews, who's done for the game with a knee problem. This is the first 7-point deficit. Pavel moves it short, and Bidette will have a chance. Jeff Bidette trying to answer Campbell's heroics. Just held up briefly and finally tackled at the 34. Maria?
Well, hey, Chris, you know, I spoke to J.K. Dobbins' parents before this game, and they said that their son looks very comfortable on the field, and I think we saw it in that touchdown run. But check out the celebration, the silencer, an ode to LeBron. That's probably because Ohio State is wearing fresh new LeBron cleats, which they all have been practicing in. I did get an update, though, from Oklahoma's Lincoln Riley, and so far he's dealing with a lot of injuries. He said Baker Mayfield is definitely dealing with cramps. Mark Andrews, he said, we will see, but he's still not putting pressure on that left leg. And also Will Johnson, a starting safety for Oklahoma, he left without his helmet in the first half, returned without his helmet, and is sitting on the sidelines right now, guys.
Maria, if you had to pick a few guys you don't want hampered, they would be in a short list. Future back tonight has been Trey Sermon. So they'll have to look for some other answers. You suggested that Dimitri Flowers will get involved. We saw C.D. Lamb, the true freshman, makes some catches early, but the receivers haven't been involved that much lately.
No, they've been using the backs and rotating the backs in and out. It wouldn't be surprised at all to see Lamb get more involved, but you're going to see Calcaterra get opportunities and also Dimitri Flowers, along with those running backs in that backfield, to continue to rotate guys in and out.
Slant. And the catch is made there for a short gain by Michael Jones, his first catch of the season. It's right near the marker. They'll move the sticks. First down.
Baker Mayfield trying to find matchups to his advantage. Soft coverage against Damon Webb. He had tight coverage on his outside receivers, so he takes the easy throw.
Guys rush four down the middle. There's a catch by the freshman tight end, Grant Calcaterra, filling in for Andrews, his first tonight.
They're going to go fast here, but Calcaterra is going to split the safeties and try to get behind the linebacker. You can't put too much air under it. You got to throw it on a line, which is exactly what he's able to do by splitting the safeties. A good route by the young freshman. That time he holds on to the ball. And again, Baker Mayfield, when he has time to throw from that pocket, he sets his feet. He's going to make an accurate throw.
13 for 20 for Baker so far. Picked up 21 yards there. Patted down at the line of scrimmage. That was big Draymond Jones again. He's been getting a good push against that offensive line.
And that's really all you can do. With the ball coming out as fast as it is, you get a push, then you go up into the air. Jones at 6'3", 295 pounds. He moves incredibly quickly and does a good job of getting up to bat the ball down. It's about the third time Baker Mayfield has had to deal with a big D lineman in the interior up in his face trying to bat the ball down.
Flowers and Sermon flanking the quarterback. And they fake it to him wide open over the middle. It's Flowers running free. Dimitri Flowers, touchdown, Oklahoma. And the Sooners answer quickly. ...36 yards for the versatile H-back.
And a changeup with two backs that you identified before the snap. We've been playing a lot of one back. This time they put Flowers back there with a true freshman, Sermon. And watch the linebackers come up thinking run, and it opens it up for Flowers to sneak behind him. They're coming up thinking the freshman's going to get the ball. Flowers sneaks in behind, and that gives you an idea what he can do after he makes the catch on Eric Smith.
Cyber ties the game. All right, Kirk, this is more like it here.
Here we go.
Making some plays.
Here we go. Got a ball game. Look at there's that energy.
Harry Mayfield
there's
here. He loves the challenge of playing on the road in front of a hostile crowd, and he's got some adversity to deal with tonight. Answers the 7-point deficit with Flowers' second career touchdown. 10 apiece.
Saturday Night Football on ABC, presented by Wells Fargo, is brought to you by the fun new Fit Sport from Honda. And Wendy's fresh, never frozen beef hamburgers are the official hamburgers of the NCAA.
Two touchdowns in 2 minutes as Mayfield to Flowers answers, and this is Baker going to virtually everybody on the travel squad, get them fired up.
Do not underestimate what that does for a team that's on the road, that has a lot of youth in some key areas. This guy is, he's like in basketball, a great point guard. You can go on the road and win with a great point guard. They feed off of his energy, and a big touchdown like that after they get down 10-3, offense hasn't put touchdown on the board. That's a huge play for Oklahoma to believe that they can win this game.
First guys he went to were the kickoff coverage team who gave up the big return to Campbell the last time. This time the kickoff is very deep. And look at the touchdown play.
Yeah, Chris, they've been able to run the ball. They've been running a little bit with Baker. They've been running with Trey Sermon. When you run with Sermon, look how it affects the defense, because they've got to come up and they get their eyes out of position. And once you get Flowers the ball, Chris and I have talked about him throughout this game, his versatility. He can be an H-back. Because of the injury to Andrews, he can play tight end. He can play fullback. They can line him up as a tailback. Brings a lot of versatility to what this offense tries to do.
Not afraid to throw a block either.
Right.
Targeted four times, and there is a head coach who's just 12 years older than his quarterback. And Mayfield told me that Riley hasn't changed at all since he's become the head coach. He's just the same guy, very grounded. He thinks very mature for 34, which is goes without saying. So can Barrett and the Buckeyes answer? They give it to Dobbins, the freshman, who makes a nice cut. Didn't look like a whole lot, but because he's so quick, he got 8 yards.
He gets to the corner in a hurry.
Hope you consider joining us for the men's championship at the U.S. Open tomorrow. Rafa Nadal goes for his third U.S. Open title and 16th major. Gets one of the great stories. Former Fighting Illini All-American, the South African Kevin Anderson, big 6'8" player. 4 o'clock Eastern time. Dobbins, look out! Oh, just a shoestring tackle made by Neville Gallimore to prevent a huge play.
This is Robert Barnes, who's a true freshman. Watch this. Watch Barnes come up and think he's going to make a play. Fell to his knees. That's the R1 on the PlayStation on Madden right there. Ran and almost took it to the house.
Dobbins could do that to a lot of guys in his career. Spinning and twisting for another big gain inside the 40. All of a sudden, this Buckeye offense comes to life.
76, the right guard comes down, gets the linebacker Emmanuel Beal. And we talked about, what is Ohio State going to do differently? Tempo and aggressive approach, and that's working for him right now.
They fake it to Dobbins, and now taking a downfield shot is Barrett for Mack, who makes a leaping catch down near the 5. Now they say incomplete. Did not control the ball to the ground. He's slow to get up. Robert Barnes was in coverage. Looked like he had it initially.
And you got to complete the catch all the way through. Boy, look, sure, this will be interesting for Dave Kataya to take a peek at this. Dave, we talk at the seminar a lot on this exact example. And this would be great for you to walk through us and the fans, because sometimes there's a lot of confusion on how do you complete the process of the catch? That looks like a catch.
Well, the whole key is that he's got a foot down here. He goes down to the ground, clearly in bounds, still has control of it. And I think there's a secondary act by that defender pulling on it.
Right now,
watch the defender.
Yeah, the defender pulls the ball out of his hands.
To me, that's a secondary act, and based on that, they can reverse this.
So let's say the defensive back did not pull the ball out of his hands, and it just came out eventually.
More than like that would be incomplete, because you've got to go to the ground. But you see he has it, and that defender looks like he's pulling it. To me, that's a secondary act. We'll see what they do upstairs.
Okay, so the secondary act would then say that you actually are in bounds, and that would be considered a completion with the secondary act.
And as you said earlier, if there was not that secondary act, we have an incomplete pass. So what they have to determine in replay is if that is a secondary act, which indicates the pass was complete before that.
Had a replay reversal in the first half by this Big 12 crew. Don Capral taking a look at it. Good job by Robert Barnes for Oklahoma to keep rip at the football. If they do uphold this initial call, it's because he didn't quit. But a good-looking throw and catch by Mack, who hit the ground hard and was a little slow to get up.
It's really Austin Mack as a sophomore, 6'2", 215 pounds out of Fort Wayne, Indiana. Really one of his first true big catches if they end up reversing this. Nonetheless, just a great effort to go up and make a play on the ball.
Mike DeFee again just checking the little monitor and conferring with Capral upstairs.
After reviewing the play, the receiver did maintain possession of the ball through contact with the ground. The ball came out, well out of bounds. It's first and goal at the 7-yard line.
So the Mack catch counts, and for the second time, a reversal goes the way of Ohio State.
And Dave Kataya all over it. The fact that the defender, Chris, you talked about how he gave great effort, but in giving that effort, he actually knocks the ball out of Mack's hands, and that's the second act that Dave was referring to.
No, he came down inbounds, though, so I don't, if he hadn't done anything, it still was going to be a catch. 31 yards sets up Ohio State first and goal. And Mike Weber is in the game. Option. Barrett turns it up. They were all over the tailback Weber, so a short gain there. Marquise Overton with the stop.
That is a great effort up front by Lampkin as well, just stringing that out.
Some tempers after the play. Oklahoma players pleading for a call. There is none. Weber is split out wide right. Now motions in. Barrett. Nowhere to run. They are focusing on the quarterback, Emmanuel Beal. Got him in a sandwich. It'll be third and goal.
Yeah, good job of attacking downhill by Emmanuel Beal. Talked about the experience he gained last year. I think you can see he plays much faster. He's trusting his eyes and he's playing a lot quicker, especially down tight inside the 10-yard line.
This wasn't easy in the opener for Ohio State to punch it in close either. Third down. Weber split wide left. JT from the pocket. Looks to the end zone. Over the head of Hill. Got a hand on it. But it's fourth down.
Oklahoma sat in zone coverage. JT Barrett has time to throw. He's just waiting for K.J. Hill to work to the corner. If he puts a little bit more air underneath that ball, K.J. Hill is able to run underneath it, just off the fingertips.
So after a 69-yard drive, Nurnberger on for his second chip shot of the evening. Made good from 24 earlier. And is now 2 for 2 from that distance. So, three scoring drives so far in the third quarter. Ohio State back on top. Our aerial coverage brought to you by Goodyear, committed to honoring blimp-worthy athletes who demonstrate hard work on and off the field. Goodyear, official sponsor of the College Football Playoff. And the trophy that will be presented at the championship game, presented by Dr. Pepper, January 8th in Atlanta, the semifinals in Pasadena in New Orleans on New Year's Day. Ohio State certainly picked by a lot of people to be in that four-team bracket. Oklahoma says, don't forget about us. So Meyer's team once again with the lead. The injuries are mounting on both sides. Austin Mack, who made that terrific catch to set up the field goal, was carted off without his helmet. His head hit the ground hard as he did complete that catch. He posted. But Depp in that corner from the 10. Not much room to run when they kick it and cover it that well. Check out our Pacific Life game summary, Kirk.
And a game that was 3-3 at halftime. Finally, the offense has woke up in the second half. Ohio State starts in plus territory. J.K. Dobbins puts Ohio State up 10-3. And Baker Mayfield, they get the ball right back, move it right down the field. Eventually, Dimitri Flowers on a play-action pass, touchdown to tie it up. And Ohio State gets the field goal in their last possession to go up 13-10. But we've seen a lot more offense just in a half a quarter than we probably saw in the whole first half.
Meanwhile, we haven't seen Will Johnson, the starting DB for Oklahoma, return. Mark Andrews out. Mayfield is playing through some cramps here. Two back look with Anderson and Flowers. What a cool night to suffer cramps. It's only high 50s, but he put so much energy into the game. It's a short gain by Anderson. And I think here comes a flag on the tackle. I think we love the intensity and the nervous energy, but you tell me in tennis that can contribute to cramping. You burn a lot of fuel doing that, getting keyed up.
Yeah. And these guys, especially.
Personal foul, shot block, number 72 and number 36. Half the distance of the goal, replay first down.
So Flowers and the left guard, Ben Powers, combining on the chop block.
And Ben Powers, left guard, is pulling around, and see him right here in the middle of the screen. Once he engages, you cannot go submarine as it go down the guy that's being blocked, and that's what Flowers did. Illegal chop block, officials right there on top of it.
It looked like Powers knew the rule and tried to back off.
He tried, but once you make contact, it's over.
So first and 21 after the penalty. Mayfield knocked backwards. And brought down at the one by Nick Bosa.
Hey, Chris, how about Eric Wren trying to make this block as a center? He's pulling outside to try to block this big guy right here. Watch this. He gets to the outside, gets overpowered with a left arm from Nick Bosa, just throws him into the backfield. And Baker Mayfield surprised that Bosa gets in that quickly.
Louder than it's been all night. Second and 30.
Loudest part of the stadium.
Play clock winding down. Mayfield steps up from the end zone and delivers a short pass out to the 10-yard line. Flowers gets some pressure yardage, but it'll be third and very long.
Take some courage to go back up into that end zone. When the crowd comes alive, Baker Mayfield trusts his offensive line to give him just enough time, just to give him a little bit of breathing room instead of having to throw halfway into his end zone.
And a closed end of the old horseshoe, vibrating as they try to make it very tough on this veteran quarterback. They need 22. Clock running down again as Mayfield rolls and delivers a short pass to Badette on the sideline. He's knocked out short of the first down by Denzel Ward. More comfortable room to punt, though.
Yeah, that's just playing field position. You're not going to pick up the first down. try to pick up 10, 12 yards, try to push Ohio State back to have to start their next drive instead of punting from maybe inside your own 10-yard line.
And Seibert, who punted just once in the blowout of UTEP, punting for the first time tonight. A.J. Hill with the Buckeyes standing at his 35. Guys come after it hard. Gets it away a little methodically. It's a low kick. Hill comes up. No fair catch. Picks it at the 40 and now decides to retreat and stays alive and will make a very exciting return for no gain. There's a lot going on there. They came after the punt hard, though, Ohio State. Got pretty close to Seibert.
I think he ran about 25 or 30 yards to get back to the, what was that, a plus one return?
Maybe. Our annual week one Monday Night Football doubleheader on ESPN kicks off Monday, 6:55, Saints and the Vikings, and at 10:15, the LA Chargers battle the Denver Broncos. So the NFL players can't come and any longer hang out and watch their alma mater. So I'll punch him around last week and get to work. It was a 0-yard return after all the excitement, but just FYI. Buckeyes with the football and a 3-point lead. It used to be a steady diet of Dobbins and Barrett. And Carranqua, another tackle. He has been a beast to block tonight.
This guy is just a big time player, not just tonight, but all year. Watch him collapse on his play. He's not even supposed to be a factor on the play, but the play was a little bit slow in developing. Dobbins waiting to kind of find the hole. He better hurry up because 31's collapsing. And holds him for actually no gain at all.
Dobbins makes a cut, but he's again dropped. It's DJ Ward. As this defensive line for the Sooners understands the moment here, they've got to prevent Ohio State's offense from just building momentum here.
Well, it's beginning at that point where it starts to become critical. Each down, each possession, because not only obviously you're trying to put points on the board, but worst case you're playing field position too. Leaving their corners on islands here.
Third and 10. Senior lineman with some very wide splits. Trying to keep Barrett in the pocket. He rolls and escapes. Thought about throwing downfield and will scamper for the 45, but he's not going to get first down yardage. Barnes forced him out. There's a flag. Back where you might suggest there'd be a hold.
I think it's going to be on the right guard. Brandon Bowen grabbed a hold of an Oklahoma defender's jersey.
See if Riley decides to decline the penalty. It's fourth down. He wants to know exactly how far Ohio State would need. He wouldn't figure Meyer would gamble from this position of three.
Holding. Offense, number 76. Penalties declined. Fourth down.
They were spotted. Yeah, fourth and five. And here comes the punt team. Good job by the Sooner defense.
Absolutely.
That time.
Three and out. Keep in mind, just a few plays ago, Oklahoma was snapping the ball offensively inside their own 5-yard line. They were able to get out of there and punt the ball away, and now a chance to get the football out after the three and out by the defense. But when they're coming after JT Barrett, they are putting a lot of pressure, not only on Barrett, but on that offensive line.
It's a different look, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Now you see Barnes down being looked at as Chrisman again will try to pin Oklahoma deep. Just lets it bounce, and that's a beautiful job. Backspin and pounced on right there. And once again, Oklahoma, for the umpteenth time tonight, will have very poor field position. Kick off your week one NFL Sunday with ESPN. New team and a new time. Sunday NFL countdown now on at 10 o'clock Eastern time. Rex Ryan, Charles Woodson, Matt Hasselbeck, Randy Moss, Shefty Mort, and the new host, Samantha Ponder. The move from the college side to the NFL. We're watching Sam.
Sammy, all the best.
10 o'clock Eastern start time on ESPN.
You know, Urban Meyer, when you sit down and talk to him, you want to talk offense, you want to talk defense. He probably takes as much pride in special teams and hidden yardage in the field position game as any coach out there. So, you know, in fact, Oklahoma is starting deep in their own territory, and they've averaged their starting position has been about their own 22-yard line. Kind of plays to his advantage. It's a stat that he pays very close attention to, where his offense starts on average versus where the opponent starts.
Crispin is a freshman. He's got the look of the guys who do this job for 4 years. Taking off is Anderson, and Rodney Anderson knocked down at the 13. A flag again. Almost a penalty-free first half, but they're beginning to pile up here. Mayfield says it's defensive holding. And Riley says we'll take that penalty. But Mike Defee has the final
holding
word.
Defense, number 93. A 10-yard penalty will be added to the end of the run. First down.
It's absolutely untrue that the crew throws flags so you can get a look at Mike's arms. There's absolutely not true. But there have been more penalties after halftime here.
Time. Tracy Sprinkle in the middle of that Ohio State defensive line, trying to keep people off the linebackers, just grabbed two Oklahoma offensive linemen, just tackled them.
Sprinkle, one of those tough guy veterans, a survivor, a fifth-year senior in this program. Mayfield pressured immediately, slithers free, and delivers the ball to the sidelines, and breaking free is C.D. Lamb, the freshman who got off to a fast start, but he's been quiet since.
I always refer to him as a young Brett Favre. The defense slants, angles this way, catches the offensive line off guard, catches Baker off guard, but look at the Houdini act. This is Baker Mayfield. That's what he does. But I got to give their young receiver, Lamb, a lot of credit working with a veteran quarterback, sees that he's scrambling, works back to him to pick up the first down.
Pinballing off his guard, Samia. 17 yards, and Mayfield scampering away again, fires downfield, has a man wide open. Michael Jones worked free. Mayfield on the run spots him, and the Sooners set up in the red zone.
Watch him get outside of six this time, Sam Hubbard, and then getting the ball out of his hands quickly allowed that ball to get over Kendall Sheffield. If he waited just a split second longer till Sheffield sinking back into coverage, he would have been able to get up there and knock that ball down. But he saw his receiver, got rid of it quick, and that's why the ball was able to elude Sheffield dropping.
Mayfield now over 300 yards passing, a guy who broke an NCAA passing efficiency record a year ago. Very sharp tonight. He's been battling through some leg issues. They fake it to Anderson. A dart across the middle. Touchdown. Lee Morris has given Oklahoma the lead. What a drive for Mayfield. Morris, a second-generation Oklahoma Sooner. His dad, Lee, was a wide receiver in the middle 80s. First time Oklahoma has had the lead, and it comes in a 92-yard, lightning-quick, four-play drive. Just a minute 40 to move also almost the entire field. Well, we didn't have many fireworks in the first half, Herbie. I'd say we're making up for it here.
Oh, no doubt about it. How about Oklahoma showing screen, kind of a delay look to the outside. They show screen left. Watch how he uses his head to get the defense out of position and then finds the receiver for the touchdown. Just a great job of Baker Mayfield looking left, showing the screen, and then the receiver who's actually showing Morris is showing that he's blocking, releases free, and is open.
Now we'll see if JT Barrett and the Ohio State offense can answer. That is a strong job by a road team.
Chris, it blocks, and it showing the screen, and then the release. What a competitor, Baker Mayfield.
I mean, we talked about what it takes as a leader and as a team to come in here on the road with a 34-year-old head coach, his first real test as a head coach. You'd say OU's tradition has established under Stoops of being a team capable of standing up to all this on the road is still alive.
No doubt about it. As long as Baker Mayfield's under center and competing, and this team's responding from his leadership, they always have a chance.
Seibert trying to take the Campbell return out of play, and he does so by just booting it through the end zone. Let's check back with Cassidy Hubbard in the studio. Cassidy. Scoring first half there.
Yeah, that one,
Coach Simpson enjoying it.
Look at his right leg.
He's beginning to show some stress. He was in here in the second quarter. It's back and forth stuff.
I can't even imagine the emotions of a guy that's always been out in the middle of this as either a player or especially a head coach for the Sooners. And now to have to be up there, just watching.
As his hand-picked successor, Lincoln Riley faces this test, and his brother Mike Stoops now tries to get Oklahoma's defense to rise up and make a play. Buckeyes have had success after halftime running the ball, and now they throw it downfield, and it was a good play to break it up. I held off because Ill Houghton arrived just at the right time. No flag.
Houghton is a junior, has great, great athletic ability, and the closing speed there is was able to separate that ball. Ball thrown just a little bit behind Marcus Ball.
The timing on the passing game, all the components that they worked so hard to get together, protection, routes, throws, still not clicking. What they do on second and 10. And they'll go back to the run game. Barrett up the middle. And it's just a reliable play. It makes it third and short.
It's just a very comfortable play for Barrett. He reads that defensive end, body language. Time he's stuck with J.K. Dobbins. Made it easy for him to pull it, pick up those yards.
Needing four, Barrett stands in and delivers a strike. And the catch is made by Victor, who moves the chains out across the 45.
Just good spacing that time against the zone defense. Talked about, you know, seeing the protection, the routes, the quarterback play, all being on the same page. That time on third down, able to spread the Oklahoma defense out, and Victor just sat in that zone.
Been hearing about Victor's talents for a couple of years now. Expected to be an impact receiver for this team this year. Now Barrett sees an open end and just scampers down near the Oklahoma 42-yard line. Another first down.
And there's a mix-up there for Oklahoma. Okoronkwo actually turns his back and runs. Watch 31 run out of the picture with a tight end. The only problem is Jordan Thomas also ran with a tight end, leaving nobody to protect the left edge for the Oklahoma defense.
And that's the kind of thing that would make Mike Stoops tear his hair out in the box. They lose contain. Final minute now of the third quarter. It's been an exciting third quarter. JT rolls and flips it downfield. Too high. Victor went up, but he was out of bounds. And again, the timing just not quite clicking. Victor was open for a time there.
He was open, but you also had Stephen Parker almost baiting him into throwing that ball. And I think that's what kept JT from turning it loose. And it's one thing the coaches want to see against Mike Stoops and the Sooners is a willingness from JT Barrett to just don't wait to be 100% sure. Just sometimes get back, trust it, and let it loose.
Dobbins fights for a short gain. And Barrett just 81 yards passing, Kirk, and 31 of those yards came on the catch by Mapp. So 50 yards total in his other eight completions. Mike emphatically making his point. Another third down play for that Sooner defense. Ohio State needs seven. Good protection. Getch was initially bobbled. Hill trying to work his way free. He's not going to get the first down. And if he'd made a clean catch, perhaps could have turned up. But as it was, Stephen Parker forced him out. Fourth down.
Yeah, clean catch and maybe turning back to the inside. He turns to the outside, and now he's got to outrun the defense. If he turned back to the inside, he probably would have picked up the first down.
So a fourth down decision for Urban Meyer to make as the fourth quarter begins. Back to Columbus after this message and a word from your local ABC station. quarter. Oklahoma has a 17-13 lead. Our Dr. Pepper Championship Drive game of the week. Urban Meyer going for it on fourth down and four to begin the final quarter from Oklahoma's 36. They're just on the fringe field goal range of Nuremberger.
Either give the option route to the inside receiver on either side or JT Barrett on the corner with option to run or throw.
You wouldn't bet against the quarterback keeper if you're Oklahoma's defense. Barrett rolls. They come after him and he'll throw downfield again just off the hand of KJ Hill. Sooners gave chase. Kenneth Murray, the middle linebacker, came after Barrett and Oklahoma makes a stand.
Well, that is a tough throw to make on the run. Murray here scraping, but look in the background at the receivers. I mean, that is a tough throw to make to try to squeeze in for JT Barrett. He actually gives Hill almost a chance to make this catch. Heck of a throw, heck of an effort, but like really, really difficult execution on fourth down.
You talk about a true freshman playing middle linebacker at this level. Yeah. I guess his head was kind of spinning in the opener, kind of a learning experience, but he showed some explosiveness to get after the quarterback there, forced the throw, and Oklahoma is going to finally have some decent starting field position. Best of the night at the 36.
Big stop by the Sooners. Get the ball back to Baker Mayfield, now up four.
Again, Ohio State close in executing some downfield throws tonight, but not quite. Sermon, heavy traffic, and no gain. You know, Mayfield's thinking, hey, let's get back to the passing game. I'm in a rhythm here. We've got guys open.
Well, he's 19 to 27 for 322 yards and a couple scores. He and Lincoln Riley in sync, very comfortable with each other, being in this role in the last couple years, play caller and quarterback.
From the pocket, Mayfield flips it short. Sprinty crosses, but dead. Man, he has some quicks. He's a featured receiver at Kentucky last year, and they are glad to have him in Norman.
Wow, incredible speed. Watch the freshman kind of lead the way. He comes out of the backfield. He's got to be careful of blocking too far downfield unless that ball's behind the line of scrimmage, but does a good job of creating a traffic jam. And give an idea what that can do when he turns the corner, gets outside of Worley. Man, he can go.
1,300 receiving yards a year ago in the SEC. Mayfield still got it. Looking downfield. Loops it down there for Lamb, who is knocked down and draws several penalty flags. There are three on the field as the freshman had to be tackled, or that would have been a touchdown.
Now the freshman got behind both Ohio State defenders. To me, it looked like Damon Arnett trying to catch up.
Pass
ran right into him.
Defense, number three. 15-yard penalty from the previous spot. Automatic. First down.
Baker's frustrated with himself because he waited a little bit too long. The ball ended up being thrown late because he waited. He had him beaten. But watch three trying to play catch up. He just runs right into the freshman. But he was beaten badly. Got behind him.
Penalty moves to the 37 as the Sooners now try to stretch the four-point lead early in the fourth. It's Padette on the pop pass. Quick penetration by Bosa. Padette able to escape and make a positive gain. Got about four. Just had to elude the defensive end of the backfield.
Lincoln Riley is getting so much attention tonight as being the head coach and his first real big game as a head coach. The thing I'm going to really appreciate tonight is the other hat that he wears as a play caller, designing formations and different looks, being multiple, giving this a very talented Ohio State defense a lot to think about even before the ball is snapped. This Oklahoma offense very, very well prepared to come into this environment tonight.
And working without their top pass catcher, Andrews, who's out injured. Sermon knocked down at the 30 by Jalen Holmes. It'll be third and short. What a way to respond, this Oklahoma team, Kirk, that the kick return by Campbell, Ohio State jumps in front. And since then, the Sooner offense has just clicked into a new gear.
You've got it because of the injury to Andrews. You've got a true freshman stepping in at tight end, Calcaterra. You got a transfer from Kentucky, Badette playing. You got a true freshman at receiver in Lamb. True freshman running back in Sermon. That's all these guys that are surrounding Baker Mayfield that are playing a lot of ball tonight.
And they lost, you know, Pirine and Mixon and Westbrook. Some studs being replaced by some very young guys. There's a slant. There is, again, Lamb, the freshman. And another first down at the 22. Boy, is he really a true freshman?
Yeah. And he's told us, it's a strong comment. For them. And you talk to these coaches behind closed doors, a lot of them are very honest with you. They said that Lamb has a chance to be one of the better receivers that they've recruited in a long, long time. They've had some special recruits and athletes go through there as a receiver. Sterling Shepard, Mark Clayton going way back. You think about some of the guys that they've had.
Nobody until him, though, had started their debut as a true freshman at that position ever at Oklahoma. Again, there's that tricky direct snap, and Sermon's got it off and running. Bangs down, still going in the 10-yard line, and Ohio State's been caught off guard by that repeatedly as the snap doesn't go to Mayfield, but a back.
Absolutely. Samia coming around the right guard. Flowers, hat on a hat. Next thing, he gets to the second level, and there's nobody there. He gives a stiff arm to the safety, Damon Webb. So kind of a slow, methodical counterplay, but they get a hat on a hat with the backside pulling around. And Sermon, who's got power at 225 pounds, running through that second and third level of the defense.
You know, and it develops faster, Kirk, because you don't have to hand the ball off to him. Just snap it and go.
He does have to pause just enough to let that guard and backside H-back come around.
Mayfield, look left, has room, now throws it. Touchdown, Sermon muscles in the end zone, and the Sooners stretch the lead to double digits. Left tackle there to congratulate the true freshman. Some guys are growing up in a hurry on the road tonight.
That's a great catch by Sermon, but are you kidding me with Baker Mayfield? Are you kidding me?
12 with his last 13.
With that throw, the way he steps up, you think he's going to maybe take off. Somehow he squeezes that throw into a true freshman for a touchdown.
You may have all those freshmen on the field. You got a veteran quarterback leading this offense. And Oklahoma making a strong statement, up 11 now on the road.
And this is incredible. This gives you an idea. Watch it. He's looking right. You're going to think, oh, he's going to take off. He's going to scramble. He's going to take off. Nope. He finds the freshman. How about the freshman to catch? Lowers the shoulder. Able to get right through to Damon Arnett.
Here's the progressive pylon cam. Mayfield is in the zone. And if they're limping around here, much of the first half. Well, 109,088 folks, the second largest crowd ever at the Horseshoe. A little bit stunned right now as the Sooners have roared back. 11-point lead. Mayfield just on fire in the second half. Seibert once again boots it too deep for Campbell to make an impact. Here's our Pacific Life game summary, Kirk.
Boy, what a different half from what we saw in the first half when it was 3-3. You can see the points, it was 4 in the third. We're just getting into the fourth quarter already. Oklahoma with a touchdown, 21 points for the Sooners alone in the second half. And Baker Mayfield, look at that, 354 yards through the air.
You're Ohio State, you've got time, Kirk, but you also got an offense that was one of the worst in the country, frankly, at creating big downfield pass plays a year ago. Worked hard on it, but they haven't really materialized in the first games so far this year. 11-11 to work with. The lead is 11. Barrett again throws low, picked off. Going down low is Parnell Motley. First takeaway for Oklahoma, and they are set up.
I think the pressure affected JT Barrett to have to really telegraph where he's going to go with the ball. You'll see eventually Murray's able to get through there, but Motley baits him. He's already sitting back here. He knows because of the scramble, he's going to have to get the ball out of his hands. He baits JT Barrett, who telegraphs the throw, and he steps right in front of it to give the Sooners outstanding field position.
Barrett's first pick of the season. And again, it's Kenneth Murray, that freshman linebacker, just exploding toward the quarterback to force a throw.
Just by him getting in and JT Barrett having to move to his right, that allows the secondary to know, okay, the ball is coming out. Motley just sat behind him, waited for it to be thrown, and then made the interception. I guess they're taking a peek to see if he got it.
Make sure the ball didn't hit the ground here. Two reversals have gone Ohio State's way. Let's check out this one.
Thought he got his elbows underneath that.
Good from that angle, not definitive.
I don't.
This one will be. He's rolling over on his hip.
Yeah, the ball never touched the ground.
Trying to protect the ball.
The ball could come out, but it never touched the ground.
Yeah, that's going to stand.
Yep.
So Arnell Motley, stepping in here.
Mike Stoops telling us this week that for the first time in a few years, he feels better at the cornerback spot despite the injury to Jordan Parker. He still has Motley and Jordan Thomas.
The ruling on the field is confirmed. Interception, first down.
And when you have guys like Jordan Thomas and Parnell Motley, and you got a couple true freshmen in Trey Norwood and Trey Brown, it affects the rest of the defense. Last couple years, because of injuries and youth, they've been handcuffed somewhat on what they could do in coverage and with their secondary. I think Mike feels very, very differently about the group that he has in the back end.
If you think about Jordan Parker, he's out with a knee injury. They lost Will Johnson, one of their senior leaders in the secondary. He left with what appeared to be concussion protocol in the first half. So now Mayfield trying to add to an 11-point lead. Flips it short to Sermon again. And the freshman staying busy tonight, picks up five.
Good. A true freshman is Sermon. And literally, you could feel him aging on every snap. Got in early for the spring, went through winter conditioning and spring football. First feel of big time football, 10 carries, 41 yards, the big catch there earlier to give him that touchdown to go up 24-13. But just playing with moxie and maturity here tonight.
Yeah, that's good penetration. Buckeyes storm through. And that's Robert Landers dropping Anderson for a loss. Eric conferring upstairs with the brain trust, hoping his defense can get him the ball back.
This is, for Ohio State's defense, a big play. If they want to try to stay within just a couple possessions and try to force OU into a field goal. Down 11, under 10 minutes to go in this game.
Third and eight. And Mayfield looping one for the end zone. Coming back is Padette. No catch. Out of bounds. Denzel Ward defended him, and it's fourth down.
Ohio State tipped their hand. They just showed him right at the beginning. We are in man-to-man coverage. Good against good. Very, very close to that left knee getting down for a reception. Denzel Ward, their best cover guy. Against Padette, that left knee comes down just out of bounds.
Let's take another look, but I agree with you. It looked like the knee hit the paint.
But how about Ohio State said, okay, we're going to play man. Baker Mayfield looked over to Lincoln Riley like, we're going to go with this? It's just, who can make a play?
It was kind of sandlot. Well, he was trying to direct the receivers.
You know, the left foot may have touched before the knee did.
Let's go to Dave Kataya. The focus was on the knee, but if the foot gets down, it's a catch. Dave, what did you see here in that replay?
I've got the toe tip down before that knee. Now watch. Here's the possession of the ball. There's the ball down. Now the knee.
Yep.
Does he have possession before the knee hits? The toe did hit first. Here's the progressive pylon cam.
No question there. The toe is down, but we can't see the ball from that angle. He has to control the ball going across the sideline.
There's another real close play.
I agree with Dave. I think he has possession.
Catch now.
Fair, foot down.
Yep. He's got it in his hands. It could not be closer than that. The knee just inches above that out of bounds when the toe hits.
By the way, another thing we don't want to look past, if this ends up being reversed, how about the throw from Baker Mayfield?
After further review, the receiver gained possession of the ball, got his left foot down. It's first and goal at the 3-yard line.
Now the folks in the upper deck and the Crimson are cheering, and Oklahoma is set up a chance to make this a 3-possession game.
How about Baker Mayfield? Again, the throw, back shoulder, away from Denzel Ward to give him his receiver a chance. Big third down, great relationship, great chemistry. Kentucky Wildcat transfer, had 28 starts when he played at Kentucky. This guy's played a lot of football in the SEC.
Had the fumble early, but has redeemed himself with a big night since. Mayfield has completed his last 12. Set up first and goal. Round end around, and barreling in for a touchdown is Jordan Smallwood. His first career touchdown, and Oklahoma is blown it open. Four touchdowns after halftime by this Oklahoma offense.
One step ahead of Ohio State with the formations and the play calls, breaking tendencies, doing things that Ohio State's not expecting. This Oklahoma team, I said it earlier and I say it again, just incredibly well prepared to come in here to win this game.
And Smallwood, Kirk, a guy who has bided his time. He's a senior, has 11 career receptions, had never scored a touchdown until this one right here. Boom, that is a physical guy to try to bring down. And Ohio State respond. The deficit is 18.
Saturday Night Football on ABC is presented by Wells Fargo. Wells Fargo, building better every day. In part by Ford, going further so you can. And Pacific Life, experience the power of Pacific.
Four different Sooners have scored touchdowns in the second half. 21 unanswered points after Ohio State took a 13-10 lead. And some in the horseshoe have decided to head for the exits.
Something about Baker Mayfield and the OU Sooners, when they get on the road and wear those all-white unis, they play with a massive chip on their shoulder.
Mayfield, there's a lot of guys on this team with some dog in them. And he meant that as a high compliment. Seibert with a high boot. And Campbell again will take a knee. This week on ESPN Sunday Night Baseball, AL Central Division leading Cleveland Indians hosting the Orioles. Coverage begins at 7 with baseball tonight's Sunday Night Countdown. O's in the Indians at 8 o'clock. The Indians are on a tear.
17 in a row. Always seem to peak the right time.
They're the best baseball team in Ohio this year by a lot, as your club is.
Well, my ball club shut her down a while back.
Did you switch over to become an Indians fan?
No. I'm one of those guys. I'm a diehard Cincinnati Redlegs fan the rest of my life. Got to stick with your team.
Let's see if these fans will stick with Ohio State. There's some urgency here. This possession down 18 to say the least. As Barrett from the pocket delivers across the middle, and Hill makes a tough catch in traffic, picks up 9.
Yeah, what makes it tough is this offensive line struggled all night in pass protection, and now it's obvious. I mean, the Oklahoma front, they're going to just come after them. They're going to do everything they can to disrupt the timing with JT.
That means keep an eye out for Obo Okoronkwo, who's been active tonight invading that backfield, number 31.
I know one thing Urban Meyer wants to see is the ability to stretch the field. Has not been able to do that at all tonight.
False start. Offense. Number 73. 5-yard penalty. Second down.
I think that's the element in this offense. Kevin Wilson's come in. Ryan Day's come in. You got Urban Meyer, all these guys are incredibly bright, great innovative offensive minds. And yet, if you don't have the personnel to stretch a field, stretch the defense, makes it very, very easy for a defense to not feel that threat and tighten everything up on the short and intermediate passing.
After the penalty at second and six, and McLaurin makes a catch. This is an offense that really, really misses Curtis Samuel, who surprised Meyer a little bit, he told me, by coming out. Noah Brown came out a year early, is sticking with the Cowboys. But Samuel was such a, he was the go-to guy when things were tough.
Yeah, but he was also, I mean, he's a great player, but he was so electrifying in space. And was more really more of a running back who learned how to play receiver. Devin Smith and Michael Thomas were the guys a few years ago that could get vertical and really threaten the defense. They haven't had that since those two players.
Barrett again has time, but nobody to throw to, and has to throw to the bench.
Again, you have three receivers there, all at about 10 to 14 yards, and you've got four white jerseys with three scarlet jerseys. It's just nowhere to go with the football.
Imperative to score and also score quickly. You need three scores to reclaim the lead. Pretty much need a touchdown each possession if you're Ohio State at this point. Then you got to try to find out a way to stop Mayfield on the other end. Barrett again stepping up, looks for somebody, flips it over the middle, and that's Marcus Baugh, first down yardage at the 45 of Oklahoma.
And even on that play where Ohio State did try to send somebody downfield, Oklahoma took it away. Paris Campbell down the middle of the field. Sooners took it away. Forced JT Barrett. They're taking all the deep stuff away when it shows up, making them throw underneath on the shorter throws. Keep the clock running if you're Oklahoma.
Finally over 100 passing yards tonight. And over the middle. And a catch by Johnny Dixon. Another first down inside the 35. Dixon, junior, who's had an injury-plagued career, decided to come back to Ohio State for one more go after being talked out of quitting because of all that knee pain. So Gallimore down holding his left ankle for the Sooners inside of 8 minutes to play. A little jawing going on. You could almost expect that from Oklahoma. They, as you said, did feel a little disrespected, a little forgotten. The 7-point underdogs up by 18. Focusing on some of the players who grew up in Florida, and while we enjoy a football game and a pleasant evening in Ohio, they're certainly mindful of the catastrophic Hurricane Irma, which is bearing down on the Keys and much of the state of Florida after having devastated so many beautiful places in the Caribbean. Our thoughts are with you. Be safe. And best wishes. Certainly most of the guys from Florida here are from that area in South Florida, which is so threatened. Barrett from the pocket, loops it downfield, looking for Victor, jump ball, and that is one of those Floridians defended by Parnell Motley.
Well, time, even though he was covered, Ohio State during that timeout, you may have had Ryan Day, who's been working very hard with G. Barrett, bringing that NFL mentality. Day spent so much time in the NFL with Chip Kelly, saying, hey, even when they're covered, you can still throw it. Throw it. Give your receiver a chance. He tried there with Victor to no avail.
Barrett zips it here. McLaurin makes the catch. He's not naturally a gunslinger, is he? Very different personality from Mayfield. So they want him to be a little bolder, right? Trust the receivers.
Yeah, and I think, you know, for him, I think he's still trying to find chemistry with these guys and really find out which each of their strengths are in these kind of games. I think that's where they were trying to get in a position last year with JT Barrett and these receivers.
They give it to Weber on third and one, and he makes a quick burst for a first down to the 16.
You know, Barrett's strength is his leadership, his ability to make plays with his feet, can create, find receivers. But at some point, as they go through this season, they're going to have to, like I said, get better at throwing the ball down the field.
And Barrett from the pocket flips it short. This is Weber, who's knocked out of bounds. Barrett came in tonight needing just two touchdowns responsible for to tie Drew Brees Big Ten career record. He's going to clearly get it at some point. Not yet tonight, though. Inside of 7 minutes. Barrett for the end zone. Throw it up, intercepted, and Parnell Motley has made his second pick tonight. And now they're going to rule incomplete. I thought he had it. He thought he had it. And then coming in saying, nope, they hit the turf. The first one was a close call.
Yeah, I thought he had it, too. I guess McLaurin trying to fight the ball out of there. I mean, he definitely initially makes the catch. Looks like he has it. Watch McLaurin try to pull at that football.
Well, he pulled it out really late.
Yeah, it looked like he was down.
They're going to buzz this down. Ohio State's trying to run a play quickly before they can reverse it, and they don't get a look at the replay in. So given a break, Barrett just throws it away. Boy, I have no idea why you wouldn't stop play. There's a flag on this play. Why you wouldn't stop play to check that out. Looked like Motley did have the interception. Be a holding penalty on Ohio State.
Well, he went up and made a play on the ball, took two steps with the ball in his hands before he went down, and then had the ball come out.
Holding, offense, number 59. Penalties declined, fourth down.
I mean, that's a pick that would have sealed the game. Another look.
Dave Kataya, walk us through there. Interception, one step.
You got a foot down.
Two steps.
He's still going.
Still has the ball.
Now, still has the ball.
Down.
The defender, to me, pulls the ball loose.
Yeah, but late, right?
Oh, absolutely.
Wow. Okay, so they don't buzz down.
That looks like an interception.
And reverse it. And now Ohio State's going to send out the field goal team. Okay. Had to cut it to 15. Theoretically, it's a two-possession game if you can cut the lead with 6:33 to play. Now, we will take a break. I've been trying to make 7 yards on fourth down. Meyer electing to send out Nuremberger for a third short field goal tonight. Cut it to 15. And expect maybe an onside kick. Kirk try to keep it a two-possession game. But not what they were looking for in this possession. Still, based on what we saw, the non-call on the pick in the end zone, Buckeyes lucky to have any hope alive at this point. And Nuremberg does his job. And it's 31-16. 6.5 to play. But some programs over time have a way of showing up on the road and pulling off upsets and just handling hostile environments. Oklahoma's that program, but Baker Mayfield is that quarterback. And you pointed out the role he's played beyond just making throws and running tonight of leadership.
Yeah, and remember, we saw him limping off the field a couple times early with possibly cramps. We don't know what the injury was, but he was going to fight through it. And his leadership, the intangibles that he brings to the table, he could see him in warmups. He was warming up with a chip on his shoulder. He's been talking to his team, the kickoff coverage team, the defense, the coaches, the trainers, everybody rallies around number 6. And we talked earlier about how many new faces are around him, freshmen, transfers. It's incredible to see what he's been able to do tonight to get this team to believe. And the other thing is this defense feels different,
yeah,
too, for Mike Stoops. Totally different group than what they've had the last couple years.
I'm glad you said that, because a defense that was reeling early last year, they were gashed by Houston, by Ohio State, gave up a ton of points to TCU, won a shootout. But Stoops told you guys he feels much, much better about this group, and they are showing why.
A lot of people are going to talk about Lincoln Riley. You're going to see what Mike Stoops did tonight as
onside
well.
Onside kick, bounces free. That's very well executed. They just couldn't get to it before it went out of bounds. But Harbaugh gave his guys a chance. There is a flag for the ball going out of bounds. So Oklahoma will get the football back. It's a 15-point lead, a two-score game with 6.5 to play.
And we talked earlier about a report card for Baker Mayfield. What does he have to do? Here's three things we talked about. Ball placement, which he's done a very good job tonight. getting the ball out of his hands quickly, under 2.7 seconds he's been able to do, and we've seen a lot of this. The creativity, really his signature play of the night, and what we've seen so many times over the years from Baker Mayfield. And there's the intangibles if you wanted to add a fourth element to what he can do.
You said a couple of times, young Brett Favre, of course, played his college ball in Southern Mississippi. When you talk about one of the great quarterbacks in NFL history, that's big praise. You're talking about
how he plays the game, the passion, the love. Young Brett Favre at Southern Miss, early at the Green Bay Packers. I'm not trying to say he's going to be the next Brett Favre as a quarterback in the NFL. I'm just saying the way he plays the game, some of the things that he does, the leadership that he provides, the way his team rallies behind him.
From the 49, this is Sermon, one of those freshmen for Oklahoma that has showed up big tonight on the road in a tough environment. Rips off nine more.
You know, not only Oklahoma wins this game, but you're talking about having guys that now are starting to become, even in the second game of the year, because of a willingness to play this game. You get ready for your next game, and the next game you get into conference play. These young players, they're not, this atmosphere will prepare them for everything that they're going to see the rest of the year. They're becoming more seasoned just by playing in this game tonight. Guys like Lamb, and talked earlier about Sermon and what he's done, Calcaterra.
Mayfield under center on second and short, just bulldozes for a first down. Baker, tell me, by the way, Kirk, that he worked hard this summer on his golf game, trying to improve the golf game. He's a lefty in golf, by the way. I don't know why. He's a right-handed thrower, but plays golf left-handed. Hits it far, working on the short game, but he says he may not have a future. Does he have the temperament for golf, the patience?
Oh, yeah.
I'm sure.
I bet he has a good time out there.
Oh, I'm sure he has a good time.
I bet he has a real good time.
He's a heck of a baseball player. A lefty hitter in baseball, too.
That's why he's golfing. His dad probably taught him at a young age. Extra step and a half, two steps to first base.
It off again, and wrestled down behind the line by Sam Hubbard. And the reminder, pop back to New York City. Love the wheels up. That Allen Henderson at 4 o'clock Eastern time. The men's championship at the U.S. Open.
Give me a quick assessment breakdown of that. I'll be watching.
Anderson's big serves against Nadal's return. Rafa will try to make it physical, extend the rallies. We know what he can do in a final. Will Anderson hold his nerves in his first ever Grand Slam final? Biggest match of his life. Nadal's been there lots of times, but it's an interesting matchup.
Is anybody in tennis even close to Nadal as far as the conditioning? Because I know, honestly, you always talk about that aspect of his game being unique. Is there anybody even close?
I think guys work hard. I think it's a much more physical sport. I didn't think we'd be sitting here talking tennis, by the way, but I appreciate the interest. No, I mean, I think what's interesting about tennis, your football is the ultimate team sport. You've got Mayfield and all these guys together encouraging each other. Tennis is lonely. You're out there by yourself in the world's biggest court.
You got your team.
Yeah, but they can't do anything for you. They can clap for you. I'm just saying it's a lonely environment. This is the ultimate team sport.
Yeah,
I love both sports for different reasons. But
well, you do a great job of both.
Hope you'll watch tomorrow. Thank you, Parker.
I will.
Sure.
I will, bro. I'm all over the U.S. Open. I love it.
No, I appreciate it.
I'm in for the Grand Slams. You go over to Montreal and some of the others, I might veer off. But
I know you're up in the middle, and I'm watching from Australia. I appreciate that. Man, Mayfield, you know, 19-20 against UTEP. It was a beatdown. He played just a half. But you come in here and you do this kind of performance with all the intangibles, 25 of 33, 381, and three touchdowns against the defense that made life miserable for most passers last year. And I know it's early. I don't want to throw out the H word, but,
no.
But Baker Mayfield has twice been in the top four and been a finalist last year. I mean, he just continues to string amazing performances together.
How many times has that ever happened? A guy three times finishing up in the top four. Has that ever happened?
Tebow was around.
Did he do it?
Won it as a sophomore and then came back twice more. But
you don't see that happen.
No.
He's off to a pretty good start at making that a reality.
Long way to go, but this was a huge hurdle to clear. Field slips it off to Flowers out of the backfield, and Dimitri spun down inside the 35 by Damon Webb. Mayfield's mother Gina making the trip up here. This is it's quite a memory. You watch your son come into this environment. You know what he went through, Kirk, by losing at home to Ohio State. You know what that loss meant to him, and to come back almost 12 months later and have this result.
Yeah, I thought it was interesting to see him come out publicly and say, not, hey, we put that one behind us. We won 10 in a row after that loss. We're not even thinking about that. No, he said, no. That stung. Not only to lose the game, but to have them sing their song on our field. That was something that we'll never forget. And he said that this week. And that kind of gave you an idea what was inside his mind.
It started in the pregame.
Oh, yeah. He came in. This is what he does, though. It's not just this. This is how he plays. When you show up to a stadium and you see Six doing this, put on your hard hat.
And by the way, he'd do this if there were no TV cameras and no crowd. If this was on an empty sand lot, you know, his guys against the other guys, he'd be doing the same thing. And that's what's cool about it. Since that loss now, 39 touchdown passes and 6 interceptions. And now, you know, Oklahoma will begin to join the conversation of those teams that are very serious playoff contenders, and the Big 12 is going to get a much needed big respect road win against the second ranked opponent, something this conference has had a hard time creating in recent years. That this will shut up some of the skeptics. It's a fourth down and 3 play. They come after him, hand off inside, and they're going to pick up the first down with Sermon barreling inside the 30. Bleed off some more clock.
Start thinking about that Big 12 and some of the teams in there and some of the road trips that they have. I know they're on the road in Manhattan in October.
It was 55-0 last time they played there on the road, though.
Yep. And then they have to go Bedlam on the road in Stillwater.
It's different, of course. Bedlam, not the season ender. There's 3 games after the Bedlam rivalry. And, of course, mindful of that Big 12 championship game for the first time. TCU looks like a serious test.
Yeah, Big League at home. West Virginia at home.
But suffice to say, they should be picking up some victories in the coming weeks.
Yep.
Without being tested too severely.
You know what it's going to be about now? Handling this. We talk a lot about Baker Mayfield. You got a new head coach. You got a lot of freshmen. And all of a sudden, after a win like this, you know how the media, you know how everybody reacts. They're just going to put him ahead. Okay, Oklahoma. And how do they respond to that? Can they block all of the compliments out? Keep this edge. If you don't show up and play like this, this edge that they've had tonight, that toughness, you know, you can lose to anybody. So that'll be Lincoln Riley's big challenge, is trying to get his team to show up upset and angry when they play in these games. Because they're a handful when they do, as we saw.
Four wrap-up shows coming up after the game, Cassidy Hubbarth. But if you think about it, a head coach who just turned 34 this week, how rare that is at his age to take over a program like this. Way back when, Paul Bryant was a head coach at 32. Most don't remember that he began his career at Maryland. Bob Knight, West Point basketball coach in 24. Think of Brad Stevens, who's a very young guy at Butler, and the Celtics head coach at 36. But there's not many 34-year-olds, actually 33 when he gets the job, come in here with this kind of command and handle this situation, have that kind of respect from his team.
Has an old soul, though, when you talk to him. I mean, just one of those guys that hasn't been a head coach, but when you talk to him, because of the poise and the way he carries himself, kind of feels that he's been a head coach before.
And the new All-State all-hands-in bus, helping us find great teamwork, great work in the community all season long. You could get your All-State all-hands-in team of the week.
Yeah, each weekend during the Saturday Night Football coverage, I'll be sharing my All-State all-hands-in pick of the week, kind of the team that came together, the strongest on the field. And can you not pick Oklahoma? Number 5 on the road at number 2. up right now 31-16. We talked all night about Baker Mayfield, four touchdowns and five possessions in the second half. And what's not there is Mike Stoops and the Oklahoma defense holding Ohio State to 16 points and shutting down JT Barrett.
Oklahoma faithful who are tucked away in the upper corners of the horseshoe where the visiting folks usually sit. They have not left. This is going to be a satisfying memory because not everybody around the country believed they would come in here and win, much less dominate Ohio State. Sermon again as a flag is down, breaks free into the secondary, barreling down near the five. But we'll check the penalty flag right at the line of scrimmage.
I think Oklahoma had too many men in the backfield.
Illegal formation. Five men in the backfield on the offense. 5-yard penalty from the previous spot.
Something to keep in mind. It's week two. But last year, because of the willingness to play a home and home, Ohio State ended up going down and losing to Penn State after beating Oklahoma. And when the dust settled at the end, the committee rewarded Ohio State for going on the road and winning in Norman in the fashion in which they did. Now you fast forward to 2017. Who knows what's going to happen the rest of the year with the playoff and the committee and how it'll shape up. But Oklahoma coming to Columbus, and right now if they hold on 31-16, that is a major, major reward and something to remember as they get ready for the rest of their season and the rest of their resume, depending on what happens.
So you're saying that much like last week's Alabama win over Florida City, it gives you a cushion. You've gone on the road. You have a huge win. If you stumble once in the Big 12, the Big 12 is a conference that sometimes had a hard time believing to get a fair shake from the committee.
I'm saying that this boosts your discussion. This, anytime you get into an either or and you're sitting there at 3, 4, 5 in late November, early December, people are going to point to this performance, 31-16 in Columbus, just like they pointed to Ohio State last year going to Norman and beating the Sooners.
Fourth and 8. Well, a home field loss has not knocked teams out. In fact, that's been a pattern to win a national championship. Yeah. Lose a game at home.
Ohio State did that in 14 when they lost to Virginia Tech early.
Bama did it again. Losing at home and then coming back and winning
lost
the championship.
Ole Miss. Yeah.
So that's the final play as they don't make the first down and Ohio State will take over. And a reminder that Monday Night Football doubleheader on ESPN kicks off at 6:55. Saints and the Vikings. And the Broncos battle the Chargers at 10:15 Eastern Time. All right, we talked about the impact on Oklahoma. What about the Buckeyes here who did not accomplish tonight anything close to what the offseason emphasis was? Develop a more dynamic downfield passing game, stretch the defense. You know Barrett can run the ball. You know we've got a couple of good backs. Beyond that, what can they count on?
What they're going to count on is facing defenses that don't respect their vertical pass game. And until they prove it, what they're going to deal with is people crowding the line of scrimmage, crowding their short and intermediate passing, and trying to get JT Barrett uncomfortable, make him sit in that pocket, hesitating. And they're going to have to come up with a plan and find some personnel that can help them stretch the field horizontally and vertically, because it makes it very, very tough if you can't do that.
Basically had, out of the four halves played so far, one good half of football. It was the second half against Indiana.
That's a hold.
Yeah, flags are down. And the catch is made out near midfield, but Okoronkwo was just dragged to the ground. This will come back. He's been a handful.
Holding. Offense.
Which was, no pun intended.
Which was
10-yard penalty from
big
the
scouting
spot.
Report, 31 in white. Against Ohio State's tackles, unless they're going to chip or slide to protection one way, he could have a field day. And he's been in that backfield all night when they've turned him loose. So you're ready saying there we got some NFL action?
Yeah. Another reminder that the Sunday NFL countdown is on at 10 a.m. Eastern time. What a great cast. You got Rex Ryan, Jeff it in there, Charles Woodson, Matt Hasselbeck, Randy Moss, Shefty Morton, Sam Ponder makes her debut. We'll be watching. From the pocket, JT fires across the middle. It's Campbell makes the catch, spins free. Knocked down, though, at the 34 inside of a minute to play. Mayfield will end this game with 14 straight completions after hitting his first 16 a week ago. In the flat, and the catch is made by Weber, who just runs out of bounds. Well, this will end with an almost empty house in the horseshoe. And some questions, you know better than anybody how tough this town can be, how loud the questions will be for Urban Meyer about this Ohio State offense. Barrett hit and hammered and knocked down. Mark Jackson, who's Okoronkwo's backup as the Jack linebacker, gets involved. Lincoln Riley, 34 years old, is going to come to the horseshoe and beat Ohio State. 40 years ago, the Oklahoma comeback was known as the kick. This is the kick butt. 15-point margin. And Riley and the Sooners win their 12th straight and continue their road mastery. Final play of the game, Hill just steps out of bounds, and that's it. Oklahoma with 28 points after halftime. They have 21 unanswered after Ohio State had taken a 13-10 lead. Come to Columbus and dominate the number two team. In the Lincoln Riley era, with Bob Stoops looking on from the press box in delight, is off to a great start in Norman.
Well, that is impressive for the Sooners. Impressive start to their season after the UTEP game, and now to come to Columbus and beat Ohio State and Lincoln Riley. Man, oh man, what a start to a, I'm sure, very brilliant future.
Well, let's hear from him after his second game. Maria Taylor with Lincoln.
Thanks, Chris. Well, I can see you guys are enjoying an embrace. What did you say to your quarterback after this match?
I didn't say anything to him. He was ready to play this game. He's the best quarterback in America, and he played like it tonight and led our team.
This team had to battle back in the second half. What allowed you to score 21 unanswered points out of the locker room?
We just fought. We knew offensively that we were really close.
Payback party here.
We played well the whole first half, and our guys just kept a lot of belief. Our defense, the way they played, keeping us in it, was great. And, you know, we're just a bunch of pretenders that are trying to win some games.
Pretenders, you're a head coach on the road for the first time. You're also a play caller. How did it feel getting the win in this one?
It's great. This is a great environment here. To win here, it doesn't happen very often. It's very, very special.
All right, I got to talk to your quarterback now, since he's the best in the country, according to Lincoln Riley. What worked for you in the second half coming out of the locker room, Baker?
I think we just stayed to our game plan, you know, stuck to it. You know, we moved the ball well in the first half. We just kind of shot ourselves in the foot once we got across that 50-yard line. I thought we just stayed with it, and, you know, the good plays will come.
The good plays came a lot. What do you feel like was kind of the difference in the connections that you were able to make downfield in the second half?
I got great receivers, and they're making plays for me. They make it easy. I've had trust in them since the beginning of throwing to them. So, you know, I'm just giving them a chance, and they're making me look good.
All right, now you didn't want to hear Ohio State sing O-H-I-O on your field.
I'm about to go down there.
I was going to say, what are you about to sing now?
I'm about to sing Boomer Sooner. I mean, I don't know. I'll do everything down there. Maybe some JT.
All right, go get after it.
Yeah, they had to file off right behind Ohio State, which was doing their tradition, swaying and singing the alma mater. And now Oklahoma's having a party down there in the closed end of the horseshoe. And this is a well-earned party. What did he do right? What didn't he do right? 16 of 17 after halftime, 228 and three touchdowns. Ohio State's not giving up 800 passing yards in his first two games. So Mayfield picked apart a secondary that's got some work to do.
Think about this. It was 3-3 at halftime. Oklahoma had moved the ball and felt like they were in control, but they just weren't able to finish and put points on the board. And then in the second half, they scored 28.
He's still got enough energy to direct the band here. So give me the flag.
Let me help my man unwrap the flag.
It took him a while to unwrap things in the offense tonight, but what a second half. Well, they don't play every year. The home-and-home series is over. So Ohio State, unless they play another 30 years from now, won't have this to worry about. But this is pretty sweet. He's going to do a victory lap. Yeah, some of you might not love this, but this is authentic. And this is because of what he felt and his teammates felt for the home field loss a year ago. He's to the 45. He's to the 50. Oh, no, he's not. No, he's not going to plant it in the midfield of the O, is he? Wow. Yes, he is. Ooh. Looks like the Ohio State band has come out of their seats. They didn't like that. There's no one here to defend the O except the band.
Wow.
But if the Buckeyes in the locker room saw that, they might come out and take issue. Now they're going to dance on the block O.
That's a little surprising.
Well, if they felt disrespected, this was their statement. Wow. That'll be talked about a little bit, as will the result in the second half performance by Mayfield and the Sooners, who come into Columbus and smack down the second-ranked team in the country. 31-16 is the final, with a furious second half by the Sooners. Tonight's game, produced by Bill Bonnell, directed by Jeff Evers. We thank our crew here in the booth. And the Ford wrap-up show is coming up next year. Mayfield taking selfies. It's a night to savor for the Sooners, a 15-point road victory as they extend the nation's longest winning streak.
Get the money, man. I'm telling you.
Hi, for Cassidy Hubbard in the studio with that Ford wrap-up show.